Here we go. Chris Franklin, Seamus Young, Jarenth Mumbles. Let's play some Civilization 6.
See, now it sounds like we're one person, and that's weird. Anyway, yay.
Is it good?
I don't know. I have not played this game.
Uh-oh.
Is it safe?
Probably not.
We don't know if it's good. That's what I came here to find out.
Unfortunately,
I have played.
Every time I have played this intro cutscene, the sound has been desynced, and it seems to be continuing that pattern. Ooh, that's really quiet.
I like how he looks like a normal guy and she looks like a Disney princess.
Yeah,
she's got like the Pixar head.
You got a really loud fan in the background.
Her eyes are bulging. There's got to be an easier way to light that.
Oh, man, I just want to jump into that gasoline. Drink it, and then become a god!
It's probably pitch.
Very briefly.
What's that?
Like tar?
So,
black.
Oh, okay.
One of the things I do like about this version of the game is that it is a little bit more... I hesitate to use the word cartoony, but it's certainly more than Civilization V was, where Civ V was very, like, modernist and aren't mankind great, and this game is a little bit more playful, I think.
Yeah, Civ V had a very strong realism bent to it that I didn't ever really like, especially since I really got into the series with Civ IV. And that game was much, much more... It had a lot more levity to it.
Oh, no. Oh, it's fine. It's a big old plane now.
Yeah, so I imagine a number of people are really annoyed by the winged hussars in the cutscene here, because there was a leak before the game.
Man, was that, it was, I know it was bugging all of us. Gosh, man. Winged
well, there was a leak before the game came out that named Poland as one of the civs, and it's not in this game, so...
Tessar is a kind of Pokemon, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Tessar is a ghost fairy-type Pokemon that lives in your heart.
Aww. Okay.
So is this cutscene just the adventures of two immortal people?
Basically. Yes, Sean Bean,
it's like that.
Who keeps dying, and Sean Bean's daughter, who, I don't know, has really giant eyes.
Sean Bean's daughter who just escaped
the
Office
trailer. And Pixar head lady.
How was the audio balance, stream chat, when it came to the sound of that versus our voices? Because to me, it's really quiet. Maybe I need to turn the audio up a little bit. Also, before we start, I want to get a quick sound off on what civilization you guys want to see me play first. We're going to do some single-player campaign here.
What are the options?
Shit.
Go Protoss. Protoss.
I just hit the wrong button,
also,
and
is
now we're
game
Brazil.
Audio at this point? Because I don't think anyone's hearing any game audio. I don't know if that's supposed to be happening.
The options are... I'm going to back out of here. The options are Rome, America, Germany, France, Spain,
Horde,
Scythia, Sumer, Greece. Two Greeces, actually. You've got
Night Elf.
Sparta under Gorgo, the wife of Leonidas, the king who died at Thermopylae.
In both Greeces at
and
the same time.
Pericles with Athens, basically.
You know how long it's been since you said a word I recognize, Josh? It's been like 5 minutes.
I know, it's great.
Can we be Catherine the Great?
You know.
The leader of Russia in this game is Peter, not Catherine.
Oh, go suck a ball.
I know, right?
Well, we're joking, but they did, I think, intentionally go for a little bit more of an obscure set of leaders and...
Well, Peter is not exactly obscure when it comes to Russian history.
Well, neither is Teddy Roosevelt, but I mean, like, they didn't go with the obvious choices for a lot of these countries.
Oh, we gotta pick Teddy. We have to pick Teddy Roosevelt.
I had a feeling some people would say that.
Right, yeah.
Obviously, there's no, I mean,
you've been using Teddy Roosevelt as your avatar for so long.
So we've got, let me read through here. Yes. We've got Catherine de' Medici as France, Cleopatra for Egypt. I would have preferred Hatshepsut if we're going for female Egyptian leaders, but whatever. Frederick Barbarossa as Germany, whose greatest accomplishment was drowning in a river. Gandhi as India, no surprise there. Gilgamesh,
I can beat that.
Gilgamesh as Sumer, which is incorrectly called Sumeria in this game. Gorgo as Greece. Harald Hardrada, as Norway. Hojo Tokimune as Japan. Montezuma as the Aztecs. Mvemba A. Nzinga as Congo.
I feel strongly that Japan should just be Mario.
Pedro II for Brazil. Pericles also as Greece. Peter as Russia. Philip II as Spain. Qin Shi Huang sounds more correct. Qin Shi Huang as China. Saladin as Arabia. Teddy Roosevelt as America. Tamiris as Scythia. Trajan as Rome. And Victoria as England.
So you can set up archaeological districts in your cities in this game. And I really want to play as Sumeria and, like, dig up ancient artifacts from ancient Sumeria and just be like the Ghostbusters version of ancient Sumeria and have that be my civilization.
It's Sumer, goddammit. So I think people really want to see me play Teddy, which is annoying because, like, America sucks in Civ, like, universally.
Ooh, they're super expansionist.
Well,
you know what they need? I admit it's true, but they've got a patch coming out that will make America great again.
So the issue, the issue with, like, America is it's a late game Civ, and by the time you get into the late game where all the American uniques come in, you've either won the game or you've lost, and, like, there's not usually a situation
where that's a big deal.
But we can play Teddy if we really want. Let's pick an old person.
Let's play Cleopatra. Well, she's hot.
The other thing is, yeah, you're right, Durson Ben. That was a terrible idea of me. I'm a bad person. the other suggestion is Rome. People are calling for Rome.
I'm down for Rome.
But I don't like playing. I don't like playing as Rome because really, what have the Romans ever done for us?
So Tamiris mumbles was the queen of the Massagetae. She's represented as Scythia here. She fucking killed Cyrus the Great, the probably the greatest emperor of Persia.
How'd she do it?
Yeah, that guy.
He died in battle. Like he was trying to subjugate the Massagetae, and she was the queen of the Massagetae. And they won, and he fucking died. So, second question is, what difficulty do we want to play on? Do we want to
go with
crank it up to max?
Just go with the default.
Super hard.
See how long I can survive.
Yeah, put it on the easiest.
No.
Put it on the easiest.
Not
difficulty.
Starting on Settler. I'm never playing Settler in a Civ game.
Settler, actually. I love playing on easy, but Settler is, like, really boring.
Let's roll King, because I'm pretty good at Civ games. I was playing Civ 5 on Immortal, which is the second highest difficulty, and winning. So, map type, I don't know if I want to do Continents, because that one takes a really long time. Fractal is sometimes fun.
Yeah.
There's no Terra
Let's
map.
Let's do something fast-paced.
Fast-paced, you want Pangaea. Map size, what is small? Small, six players. Six players sounds good.
Based on my experience, that number might be a little optimistic because the size of cities is so much bigger now with the districts. a small map holding six players is going to get crowded pretty quick. I was bumping into people very early. Like, not just, like, meeting people, but, like, literally bumping up borders pretty early.
Hey, happy birthday, Nick!
To man taking his first upright steps, you have come far. Now begins your greatest quest. He's 30 now. We're both old.
Yay!
Happy birthday, Nick.
Welcome to the club.
Welcome to the club. I was going to say.
What's your favorite thing about being 30?
Or it is from the back of your stallion that you shall look upon and lead this side in.
Come on, baby.
So I have dementia now. I'm 30.
Okay,
I'm pretty sure that still makes you the youngest dude in here, so don't worry about it.
I'm not.
Phallus and Steven.
Right, they just fall out at 30.
Yeah, I remember my bowels.
See, her ability is Killer of Cyrus.
They were great.
Alright.
Oh man, check out her braids.
Looks like garlic nuts.
Nick is cute. Thanks for saying so.
Wait. Oh no.
We got chips on there.
This looks a little better.
Please.
Yeah.
Pixar, it didn't happen.
Like,
compared to the me and Josh
like,
did a quick test earlier, and
I got,
started in the worst possible.
I got fucking two stone and marble here.
Not a lot of food.
So wait, yeah, that's the issue. We got weed up here, but that's too far away from here. What?
You're not going to use marble to just build houses or something.
Yeah, marble is a kind of stone.
That's not what you use marble for. It's luxury.
No, you make that increases wonder production usually. We got cattle here, which does probably help with. How do I see tile yields? Map. Okay, show yield.
I think
icons.
It was just hold mouse over it, wasn't it?
Plains weed is probably not that a big deal.
Place.
A good starter place has good luxury resources for money and good food for growth.
Yeah.
Good starter has to be able to beat at least the first two gyms.
Oh, yeah. I got all my gym badges.
Did we go with Pangea?
Yeah, we're on Pangea. So the question is, do I go and settle on these cattle, or do I keep them here? Because like, we got cattle and rice here and then rice over there. I think this is a good spot to settle.
You'll need just a mod kidding. If you're gonna do that.
Yeah, let's
so
go ahead and
very
find
much
the city
like,
here.
Like Civ 5 and Beyond Earth, in just like general layout.
Yeah. So we've got two different research trees now. We got the typical tech research here. But then we also have a civics research tree. This is unlocks like new cultural stuff and new government stuff. So Code of Law is the only one we can research right now. But in technology, what do we want here?
Oh, that's an interesting system.
When do I get my unique?
Because I've been playing with how to implement civics.
So that's
in basically every
I know we
game.
Already, I know we already discussed the visuals, but this I really do like this better than the look of Civ 5. Oh,
no, it's really
this
nice.
Makes me want to play the game. Yeah, makes me want to
play.
The
Fog of War. The Fog of War is really cool because once you leave an area you've already explored, it renders it in this like sketchy mountain, like a pirate map kind of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that sounds cool.
And I, yeah, I just, I've been holding off because the game is $60 friggin', but I might get it. I might get it based on this stream.
Let's grab a scout before we grab a monument.
Come on, Sid. This is your one chance to get my $60.
Yeah, this game looks really good.
Based on
make it count.
Although, I
based
cannot...
Based on the changes I've seen, I've played up into about the mid-game, and I really like a lot of the design choices they've done. They've really tried to emphasize having the systems bounce off of each other a little bit more, and it's pretty cool.
Do we really
can
want...
you go to space? I feel like the best Civilization game would take place in space. Am I right?
I think this
okay
game,
game.
When you finally
I agree.
When you finally get to the end of the get to the end of the tech tree, this game should just seamlessly transition to Kerbal Space Program, and that's how you launch your rocket and win the game.
That would be cute.
Why
is that not increasing the speed that I'm getting? It says 13 turns here to grow. Why is like selecting the food not increasing that growth speed?
Because it doesn't. I don't think it calculates until you go to the next turn.
Oh, okay. In that case, we want to put more into growth than that. So let's continue scouting with our warrior. Head him down here on the hills where you can see further.
Beyond Earth, I added that to my wish list ages ago, and it kept going on sale, and I was like, not yet. Yeah, not yet. Okay, and then it's down to $30. Yeah, not yet. And I think it went down to like $15 or $20, and I'm like, yeah, I think I'm just never getting this game.
Yeah, okay, six turns is way better. I heard bad things about it.
Yeah, but the criticisms is that it's bland, and that is kind of very much true.
Yeah, I was going to say, one of the things I love about this game that addresses a lot of the concerns I had, issues I had with Beyond Earth, all of the Sid leaders here are done in this real big cartoony style. It actually turns off some people, the big, like, they almost look claymated, but I like it.
It feels a lot, it looks a lot more like Civ 4, I think. Like, if you made Civ 4 today, it looks like Civ 4.
Yeah.
Would look,
Oh, no, I'm sad about Leonard Nimoy.
Yeah.
Aww.
We got Sean Bean.
I'm genuinely sad.
Ooh, Barabian Scout. Let's...
I'm sure Sean Bean is great.
Barbarian Scout.
I still think he should die halfway through this game, and he should be hastily replaced with one of the programmers that narrates all the technology from that point on.
We met Brazil, and he's not
Brazil.
Talking at all.
Brazil.
Oh,
that's weird.
Do you speak Portuguese? Otherwise, it's going to be hard.
Well, he wasn't saying Portuguese either. He was just like, his lips were moving. We had the subtitles, but no sound was coming out.
That's weird. I haven't seen that book.
Let's dance some samba with Brazil.
Like an early Stone Age civilization right now. But this guy has already invented medals and shoulder pads.
Yep, that's it.
Steal
he's
his
pretty
jewels.
Ahead on the tech tree.
Take his family jewels from him.
We got
sweet.
And shave off his
family. Are you talking about the stuff he's wearing? Or...
So that's definitely different than in Civ 5, where I would be able to attack this guy here.
Yeah, they're trying to formalize war a little bit more.
Which is good. That guy's on a hill. Oh, he left the hill.
Reconnaissance units like scouts.
Okay, I know what scouts do. Thank you. Let's see, what do we want to build here? Let's get a monument going.
This party started. Oh.
We don't have part
that may be the wrong decision, actually. Let's actually, how do I change that? Let's change that to a builder, because we're going to get mining soon, then we'll be able to improve some of these.
So, have you done any research on what the changes to builders?
Yeah, I know some about this game. I've kind of pointedly avoided, watching other streams. But I kind of have an idea. That's a spearman. I don't feel that great about... You know what? Pedro, you can deal with this shit. I know, some stuff about this game, but I've never played it, and I haven't really watched anyone, play through much of it. So I know, builders, they have charges instead of just being, constantly sitting around, and once you use up those charges, they go away. But those charges, build stuff instantly, so... What?
That's, again, very taken from Beyond Earth. And it's explored.
Yeah, he's also not talking.
It feels like whatever they took from Beyond Earth was sort of... I don't know why you're running into this. That's weird. It's cool because they actually speak
also
the language, and I like picking out words that, I know from that language.
Way over there.
Wow,
who's this
leader
old guy?
Of Rome has a chicken neck.
Trajan?
Look at that guy. He looks like
he was
push.
Known as the best
over.
Of emperors.
I bet you can get right behind him.
Yeah. Ooh! Mm-hmm. Found a natural wonder. Unfortunately, it's sitting in Tundra.
Ugh. True to Kaiser.
Tundra.
Okay, this that's really cool how it revealed waters.
Yeah. All right,
yeah,
let's grab
a wonder, pile of big rocks.
So something else that we've been getting is these Eureka bonuses, where if you do something in the game, it'll give you knowledge of a particular technology equal to half of its bar. So like if we allow a builder to embark, we'll get knowledge of sailing. If we build a farm resource, we'll get knowledge of irrigation and so on.
I did like that the game was like, you met another civilization. You wish you had somebody to write this down or something. And then you got half of writing.
What is this thing exactly?
It'd be nice if the interface was just blank until you developed writing. There'd be no words on the interface. It's entirely picture.
Just like scratches.
Yeah.
And piles of rocks for counting.
Tutorial windows would come up and they're just all these scratches. And
I love the way the map
below,
looks
and you're
now.
Like,
with the like fog
no, it's
of war
gorgeous.
Being drawn map and the rest being like map. We're like, oh, it's
yeah.
We don't know what's over here. A great big boat.
Could be a boat. No boat.
It could be a
I
giant
am disappointed.
Boat. That's what I was hoping for.
Yeah, fuck that scout up.
Wait, who are you rooting for right now?
The...
Wait, barbarians have
my
scouts?
My warrior. Yeah. They've always had scouts. Well, for a while, anyway. I don't know. About, like, since Civ 1. Or, not Civ 1. Since Civ 4.
Puppy.
Since the first one I played very much of. Oh, man.
So why are we exploring the wastes?
Well, for one, we kind of want to figure out where the, barbarian encampments are, but also we want to find some tribal villages and get some bonuses if possible. That's what early game Civ sort of is about.
Do. Yeah, but like, we'll shouldn't we be exploring down towards the continents?
But, I mean, this is the continent. Oh, Jesus.
Whoa.
What is this?
That looks like a barbarian attack.
Oh.
Alright, we're gonna run our scout back so they can help out.
Oh my god, that is
a short
brutal.
Game.
Yeah, this is gonna be a real short game. Josh wanted to play on, like,
King
expert.
Cities.
I'm on King, it's one attack, it's one difficulty higher.
Man is the noblest of all animals.
Did they keep, like, the autonomous city attacks in Civ 6, or did they take that?
I don't think they did. Josh, click on the city and see if you have an option to, but I don't
what,
believe
what is
you
it?
Can.
What was the question?
Do they have
the
thing where the
city
itself
city
can attack? Yeah.
Yeah, they took that out. Okay, so now we've gotten our first government. We're a chiefdom. And we have these policies here that we can add to things, so...
So,
we probably
really
want
like
discipline.
System.
Yeah, so these are basically cards that we can put together here.
Yeah, this looks pretty neat.
God King. So we're a disciplined God King. And you can switch these out.
Cool.
I like it because it reintroduces a lot of that sense of sculpting a government and a little bit of role-playing-ness that was absent in 5.
Yeah.
I like
5 was just
back.
Like a straight-up RPG tree that wasn't all that interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Is Gandhi still a dick in this game?
Is India in this game?
Yeah, Gandhi's in this game. Gandhi's always
going
to be in Civ.
Yes, and Howell suggests adopting code of laws so you can outlaw barbarians, and that would probably solve the problem.
Yeah, that's it.
But is Gandhi a dick? That's the really...
Probably?
...than if he's a dick.
I mean, he's only a dick once he gets nukes, right? That just sets off his power hunger.
This is one of the things I'm not sure about, the civics tree. So to unlock those cards that you can plug and play into your to your government,
yeah.
You have to unlock civics, and they basically get researched by culture. So now culture doesn't determine cultural boundaries like it did in the previous games. Culture is invested in so that you get more civics so that you can make progress on other cultural bonuses.
So we're not likely to discover a second continent on Pangaea for foreign trade. But I don't know if we really want.
So then what does determine the borders?
Huh?
Is it just population again?
Culture. Yeah, culture always determines borders.
But doesn't in this game.
Not historically.
I have a question from Chad. I don't understand it, so here, I'm just going to ask you guys. So the civics are actually more like interchangeable religion bonuses from 5?
Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
Kinda, yeah. But there also is a religious system here, so...
Let's see. How do I... Is there a city view option, even? How do I see...
Yeah, you know what I haven't seen yet is, like, the view of a city. Like, what tiles are doing. Is that gone? Like, you used to open...
No,
up.
Because they're using
no,
tiles.
Okay. I can do this. Stop putting people...
So there is no separate view of a city. It's all on the world map.
You can name your religion? And
yes.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you can make your own religion. And that seems weird. Like, this is the view I think you're talking about, Seamus, right? The one with the... Where you can pick where resources are allocated?
Yeah, yeah. But it used to be a separate screen and everything, and now I guess it isn't. It's just
maybe it does go up with pop. It used to be culture that.
But you know, it makes me think. Why did it take? It's one of those changes that now that they've done it, I was like, why didn't they do this before? It seems so obvious. But then I never thought of it.
Part of the reason is in this game that the city itself has districts that take up an entire tile, and we haven't gotten that far yet. But The new game lets you be able to, like, we could declare one of those tiles to be a science district where we build library, or a campus district where we build research labs or libraries or whatever, and you're basically trading whatever the resources that are there for taking up a spot that uses, that lets you build those things. So you can zoom into a city real easily and just see on the map, oh, this is a science city because they've got a campus with a library and a college.
Huh? Oh, I can't.
As opposed to having to open it up.
Did Josh just lose?
Maybe.
I'll tell you what, Josh, you've got this city totally surrounded. These guys are screwed. Wait, you're the red guys, right?
Yeah, that's it. Definitely the red guys. Let's get a slinger here.
Don't attack across rivers.
So Rome. Can you still harvest those
Rome is trading
those
with us.
Tiles that the barbarians are on?
I don't believe so, but it didn't say that those tiles were unworkable right now.
Rome was like, we're trading, here's some cheese. And then it didn't mean anything. Or did it? Did you actually get some cheese?
No, cheese is not a luxury resource.
You're always hungry.
Animal husbandry. Those barbarians are screwed now. They're like, shit, these guys have animal husbandry. Let's get out of here. They're going to wipe us out.
Ooh, promotion available. All right, what are we doing here?
Losing.
Losing?
Naming your religion after me.
I think I like what Chad is saying. The religion should be called cannibalism. I feel strongly that's correct and moral thing to do.
See if we can get a religion here quickly.
Which is cannibalism.
I'm going to sleep the builder here lest we get totally ruined. I don't want to actually attack that guy because I'll end up going across the river and that will... I wonder why the slinger wasn't attacking. Oh wait, you have a promotion. Shit, how do I do that?
It's in the little menu down in the right corner, lower right corner.
I like the thought that your king, it just never occurred to him to, like, promote his own guys. He's like, wait,
okay,
shit, if I make these guys all captains,
right,
they'll fight way better.
Yeah, it takes up a turn to promote people now, which is weird. I guess the idea was they didn't like...
Sure. We'll be friendly with Brazil.
But a turn is like a significant amount of time, right? It's like a year.
Right, like 20 years at this point in the game.
There we go. Promotion available.
Yeah, it's several years.
It's quite the promotion.
It's like half a lifetime.
Faster movement in woods and rainforest is probably better than
I mean,
hills.
That's the way time worked in the other Civ games. It's like your first few turns are like 50 years. You know, it takes you like 50 years to settle your first city and like do your first couple turns. It's crazy.
I'm gonna heal this guy because he'll just end up on the other side of the river and get pounced by that completely healthy barbarian otherwise. Thanks, Trajan. I'm a little busy here dealing with like 60 billion barbarian units. I guess he doesn't like people who don't expand.
Would you like to trade some more cheese? I would like to survive. Is he smack talking you because you're not expanding fast enough?
Yes. That is what is happening.
That is amazing. I love it. Like, what are you, chicken?
Alright, let's move the, how do I select the, there we go, the builder, and go improve this resource here.
No, your border's just expanded, and you still only have two populations, so it's not purely,
yeah, it's gotta be culture.
It's not purely population.
It could still be a culture thing. Like cities.
Oh, city
culture.
Details, here we go. Citizen growth.
Ew.
That's how many citizens we get.
Need to get that looked at.
Amenities, housing. Don't know.
I love how detailed this is. And there's a similar screen, by the way, for a diplomacy when you're dealing with somebody to give you that level of detail of why they think of you, what they think of you. It's a pretty nice interface. It takes a while to get used to, but I like what they've done with these little... It almost looks like they've taken a lot of notes from Apple design, where everything sort of slides in and out and has tabs. It's like a popover list of here is how the game is currently working.
Oh, shit. That's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to... Well... Alright. Let's move you over here. Put you back in the city. Unfortunately, you can't attack this turn anymore, but sure.
I like how this game is voice activated now. And you go over there. You go here.
Let's get a monument going.
I'm sad this game is not Vive compatible.
Oh, they're running away now. Got him on the ropes!
You know what's so
that
famous?
Would look really... What mumbles?
I was gonna say, when I do my Dragon Age Let's Play, I start talking to all of everybody. I'm like, you go here. Okay, you get a heals. Okay, make sure you attack that guy. It's the same thing.
Doesn't everyone do that?
Yeah.
It'd be weird if you don't talk to your video game characters, as if they're like...
That's why I don't stream, because that's how I'd play. It would just be me being perfectly silent for hours. It would be me streaming Minecraft, but then, like, every 4 minutes I'd alt-tab and, like, dick around on Twitter.
Man, I want to join... Good.
Go ahead.
Sorry.
I was just gonna say, shame it.
Damn it. Mexican stand.
I forgot what I was gonna say. Go ahead, Campster.
I was just gonna say Seamus, but he would still have the mic plugged in, so he'd be like, you'd be seeing someone play Minecraft, and it would just be Minecraft audio, and then occasionally you'd just hear like a heavy sigh, or some other, like, ambient audio.
Just the gameplay footage stops streaming for a little bit, and you hear someone getting up and walking to the kitchen and boiling a pot of water. That's the content we're here for.
Tea chat.
You joke.
So this river you're looking
about
at.
About empty.
It kind of looks like this river of yours starts in a lake and then goes to the ocean. I'm not entirely sure how that's supposed to work.
So yeah.
I have to say, I am impressed that we are still alive.
We're gonna lose there, Campster. It did, however, somewhat delay our initial expansions to... Oh, hello.
Everything. Delayed your doing anything at all. Except fighting barbarians.
Just keep you watching for barbarians in that direction.
They're just so envious of our awesome city not quite on a hill.
Skill without imagination is craftsmanship. We should go knock their city down. And gives as many
useful objects. So we get Sean Bean talking. Alright,
he should voice the barbarian.
Ancient and classical No, I like... I don't actually know if I want... What is this Starth? Oh, that must be Great People. 3D production towards builders. Or... No, let's keep God... Yeah, I don't want to change any of those.
So you can just switch this out on
so
the farm.
So we're going to get a Eureka moment, moment for archery here, because we're about to kill this guy with a slinger, which is our Eureka moment for that.
I actually don't know if you...
Boom.
I don't know if there's a turn of anarchy for switching governments.
I think that's how it works now. Like, it said that, like policy changes are free when you get the new civic stuff, but, like when you research a new civic tree thing, you get free changes. Maybe it costs money or something instead of anarchy. I don't know.
It's very Civilization 3 of them.
And 4.
I mean,
4
at the same
thing.
3, so I'm not complaining.
And 2 had anarchy. Actually, 2 actually had anarchy no matter what. You discovered something that would give you democracy, and then it would be like, if you want to go to democracy,
ooh,
that's great, but you're going to be in anarchy for one term while we figure out this government thing.
Figure out how this works.
So the problem I have with the civics tree is that it doesn't really make a lot of sense. Even less so than technology. Like, technology, you could argue that even though in real life technology is not really a tree, certainly some technologies lead to other technologies.
Yeah.
In civics, I don't know if you could really establish it as sort of a linear hierarchy of civic engineering, civic, sociology sort of stuff. Governance and philosophy don't work that way.
Lock you two and bring this one over here so we get some more work. That doesn't give us that much more work.
Yeah, that thing. And click on one of those other things. Then
why does the marble give us food?
There.
Oh, I guess that's just from...
Right. And then look at that little...
Shut up, Seamus!
I'm helping!
You're not...
This is what you're doing!
You're
I'm backseat driving. I thought if we were both doing it, you'd play twice as good. It's like we'd like take twice as many actions.
Let's get military tradition here.
I kind of like the game board graphical style of it. Where if you scroll up to the edge, there's just a background. It's like you're looking at a tabletop.
My wife came over, looked at the game, and it's like, wow, it really looks like Settlers of Catan.
It does. Between the hex grids and the bright colors, it does feel a lot more like that than the previous Civ games.
I'm torn. I want to play this, but I don't want to pay $60 for it.
Oh, did you get a promotion? He got a
promotion. Yeah, I'm kind of feeling that too right now.
Do not buy it at $60, Shamu.
Yeah.
You'll regret it.
I pre-ordered this from Gamersgate and got it for, like... Well, I ended up paying $60, but I did
the
deluxe
version. The website.
Yeah, not Gamergate. Yeah, it's an unfortunately named thing. Wow, that guy left his fucking encampment. Hello.
Take the encampment.
It's yours now.
This is now my encampment.
Now you get to be the barbarians.
That would be a cool mechanic.
Your guys immediately take their pants off, put on furs. Put on furry hats.
And now the barbarians can take over your city. That'd be a cool gameplay mechanic, though. If you could actually start out as barbarians and they just conquer a different civilization.
Oh, they promoted themselves.
Like,
excellent.
Getting back to paying $60 for this game, like, I want to play this game, but I also know Dishonored 2 is coming out, like, soonish.
Also, Call of Duty Infinite Warfare with the spaceman shoots. And
obviously I'm going to get that.
Serious storyline about being a spaceman who shoots things.
I have to find out how it ends.
Let's put you into the city.
The final chapter in the epic Call of Duty saga.
I'm interested in that. I probably shouldn't be.
I'm interested in Battlefield 1, and I probably shouldn't be.
May the forces of evil become confused while your arrow is on its way to the target.
What is this secret Hitler that I'm hearing about? Is this a joke?
It's
is
a,
this
a
meme?
A,
that
no, it's a game.
It's a board game.
It's
oh,
game.
Secret Hitler game. I see.
Oh wow, we can straight up just research horseback riding. Sweet.
Is Secret Hitler all about figuring out which one of you is Hitler?
Yes.
So every time we start around, everybody would just immediately guess Josh, and it would always be Josh, no matter what.
Well,
yes.
No, because the Hitler is chosen at random.
Yeah, and it would end up being Josh every time anyway.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, mm-hmm. That is true.
The barbarians really are just so much more intense in this game.
No, my marble! You monsters!
Did they take it?
They you lost
pillaged
your marbles?
It.
They pillaged. I can just imagine these barbarians heaving these giant blocks of marble up over their heads and running off with it.
This is gonna look
tonight
great to the barbarian encampment. Oh, isn't the surprise going to be on them when they come back to the barbarian encampment and see that Josh lives there now?
Do we want to try for Stonehenge? Or do we want to get a holy site up?
I don't know what either of these things mean or do.
Stonehenge is a wonder, a
yeah,
holy
I
site
mean,
is a
I
district.
Would have thought that, I would have thought that Stonehenge would be a holy site. I mean, it was for somebody at some point, so...
As far as we know...
Or think.
What if it was just a cool
well,
place to hang
build...
up your laundry?
Was an...
what?
Yeah, I was just about to say they didn't build all that shit for like.
Go for it. It's actually let's get another builder here so we can get some proper production going. Then we'll
I was gonna say it wasn't like some guy built that whole thing just to impress a girl, but then I was like, actually, maybe that actually is what happened.
That didn't do anything.
I'm pretty sure I don't know what you're talking about. So, this whole district thing that I was hearing about, is that
Bravely,
something they're gonna do
he's being the only
anytime
one
soon?
So, as I gather, you don't build stuff in your city, you just turn tiles on the board into districts of your city. So instead
yeah,
of having
also
like,
still
you,
building
yeah,
stuff
you
in
can
city,
build
right?
buildings in your city, but districts are things that you place on tiles.
Oh, so you do both? That's
yeah.
confusing to me.
Wait, what the hell is
want this
plus 100% production towards ancient and classical era heavy and light cavalry?
Yeah.
That is incredibly specific. So that's basically your government is making horses up until the point where we don't make horses. How is that your government?
It's a cool government, Jarenth, is what it is.
It's horse court.
We're still on our first city.
Yeah.
Like, is it like
it's not going
1800
super great.
And we're we're still trying to
it's
get out of
it. 2720 BC, Seamus. I should probably expand.
It's basically
here,
the
soon.
Same thing, Josh. Alright, my empty cup is telling me that the time of tea getting is upon me. I'll be back.
Get the tea.
I send you to repair it. No, probably not.
Hmm.
scout. Oh, we can upgrade this to an archer. Do we have the gold for that? We totally have the gold for that. Yeah. Alright.
So, what's happening, Josh? Brief is on the state of your civilization.
Well, Brazil just killed that barbarian camp, which is good.
What are we doing? Someone summarize. Did a
barbarian just teleport?
Fighting off
existence?
Barbarians, getting ready to expand. I got a few. Oh, there's the.
Cool. Oh, so the same scout. Shit we've been doing for 20 minutes now.
Yeah. Whoa, there's another barbarian
camp
here.
That's the civ experience.
We made classical era. Does that put us in classical? Yeah, okay. So they're only slightly ahead of us.
See, so on the one hand, I have this thing where I'm looking at this and it's like, yeah, that looks cool. I kind of want to play it. But on the other hand, it also just looks very incrementally changed from the previous civs.
I imagine you don't get to see any of the cool stuff until later on.
We just spent 15 minutes dicking. This is when civilization drives me crazy. It's like, okay,
oh, we got a religion.
I defeated a barbarian encampment. Now it's time to
move on. Well, we got a pantheon, not a religion.
Oh, shit, another barbarian encampment. And you just spend like an hour of the game dicking around with barbarians while the computer builds up. And after a while, I feel like, oh, this is so pointless. I should just restart the game.
And that's why I don't like playing anything higher than Prince, just because of that. Especially, apparently, in this game, the barbarians are even more aggressive than they usually are.
Yuck. Yeah, I don't like highly chaotic random elements like that. Like, just the... I understand they're there to make sure you build defenses and kind of keep you on your toes. So you don't, like, wait until you meet somebody before you build, you know, your army or whatever, but it... You know, some games you won't have any barbarians and you'll just grow like crazy, and some games you'll just get hounded. And I feel like that's too much chaos.
Plus 50 faith for each Bahrain outpost cleared sounds pretty nice.
So, we're founding our pantheon right now. If you weren't paying attention to the stream, we're starting a religion, mm-hmm. just like you guys wanted.
Mumbles!
It's not a real full religion yet. I don't know if we can even name it.
It's more like a pastime at this point.
That's gonna get, like, useless later on. Border expansion or city growth increasing is something that'll keep with it for the whole thing.
You wanna go down to the sacrifice pits this weekend? Maybe throw in some goats?
Mines over strategic resources plus production from that is not bad. Plus food for some luxury resources. Plus culture for some other ones.
Or we could just embrace your inner lunatic.
Let's do... Why, plus 15% reduction towards ancient and classical wonders.
Oral tradition fits with the stream where you're just talking over each other all the time.
Don't... Hey, guys, do me a favor. Just don't look at chat. Just keep watching your nerd
what
civilization stuff.
What did you do, Miles?
I'll be totally honest. As old as my eyes are and as slow as I read, it's just a blur.
That's good. Good.
Trajan is like playing life coach for me. Like, come on, get a fucking religion, dude. What are you doing?
Wait a minute. Now I am reading chat. Is this your doing, Mumbles?
What?
No.
What is happening? I don't have time to read chat.
I can do what I like.
It surprises me that he doesn't say, believe in my gods that we already found, but he's like, you gotta believe it's something. She's not even being a jerk about it. She's just, yeah. Maybe you should pick up a god.
Wait, remove improvement? That's not what I wanted. Fucking... Why would that even be an option?
Because you could send workers in and pillage your own stuff, or not your own stuff, but other people's stuff.
Shit. Stonehenge your butt.
She says we gotta come in here and take down these mines.
Are you sure that's what the work order says? I'm sure. The boss signed it himself.
It's signed right here. Yay, we're building a district.
No, we're building a wonder, dude.
What kind of district?
Oh, wonder.
What kind of wonder district?
We're building a wonder and we still haven't founded our second city.
Do we know how to write?
No hour of life is
Man,
wasted.
This is gonna be... Somebody's gonna come along and and conquer this city easily in a few centuries, and they're gonna be like, wow, this is a nice city that we just conquered. Somebody did a really good job on it.
Fuck you, Seamus.
So I got a question. If you build your wonder far out from your city, which is a thing you could do just now,
yeah,
can barbarians come by and stomp on it?
I don't think they can permanently remove it or anything like that. If that's the question.
I would love to see barbarians attack the Great Pyramids with their spears.
Some writing
I would
shit
love
going
to,
here.
I would love to see them.
Just
they
topple
can tear
stone
it down, but it'll
like
take
a bunch of
2,000 years.
I haven't run into this situation yet. I don't believe they can just dismantle wonders, because those are just so ridiculously hard to build. I know they can remove improvements, so they can totally screw up other things, but I don't think they can screw up city things without taking the city.
That's kind of disappointing, though. I think that'd be funny if it happens to other people and not to me.
Alright, let's look at our citizens here.
Or like, at the very least, if they can destroy it, just go squat in it. Make it like a new barbarian camp. Suddenly your Great Pyramid is full of barbarians. So what the hell is that stuff on the top left? Are there like magical crystals?
Oh good, at least those removing that thing stone. Didn't eat my... thing. Okay, good.
I'm gonna choose to believe they're magical crystals.
Those are gypsum.
Exactly, that's what I said.
How do I find... Oh, right, I can't just click on it anymore. So, let's pull you off of there. Oh, there we go. That works. 12 turns to Stonehenge, provided nobody steals it, which is probably gonna fucking happen. Let's figure out where we want to put our next city.
Short, it is Stonehenge equally turn over. To have a happy and engaged workforce. 12 turns doesn't feel like a lot. Profitable bottom line.
Plus 15% production towards ancient classical wonders. Let's do that, because we're gonna wonder whore here. 10 turns to Stonehenge. This is me getting a religion for you, Mumbles. That's the whole point.
Yay!
What's a purple? Oh, you don't have purple card
slots.
Okay. He needs to get a government that supports a purple. I don't know what the purple
is. Purple is wild card. I can put that in anywhere, I believe.
Oh.
If I were to... I think I could put that in any slot. Oh, wait, no. Is purple wild card? Or is purple culture?
Open the thing back up.
No, there's diplomatic, which is green, economic, which is orange, and military, which is red. So purple is wild card, and just gets to be put in any slot, I believe is how that works.
Well, there's the wild card slot down there.
Yeah, that'd be silly, though. Is there a wild card slot specifically for wild cards?
Yeah, I think the wild card slot... Is
allows you to put anything in it.
Cultural.
Yeah.
Right.
We got marble down here and gypsum and whales. It might be good to put like a city right here or right here. You can build like dock districts and stuff, can't you?
Yeah, harbors and some other things.
So you can befriend the whales?
Yes.
You can turn them into a
We're
resort.
We're going to Star Trek this
sell.
Shit.
Alright, unfortunately I have to take off because I have not eaten yet, and it is 7 p.m, and food is good.
Okay.
Oh, really?
Good luck.
That is a true thing.
Good luck,
Camp.
I will be back. If you guys are still streaming when I get back from food, I will rejoin the stream, but if not, maybe I'll stream something else.
Yeah, Josh might lose before then, so eat fast.
We'll see. Anyways, I'll catch you guys later.
Yep.
Okay, this is from the chat. This is very important instructions, Josh. Josh needs to put the thing on the stuff so we can get the other thing and win all the games.
I never thought of it that way.
Who said that? Oh yeah, look
Tricks
at that.
2001. Bam, bam.
It's actually really good advice, but Josh isn't going to be able to see it because he can't look at the stream chat.
I can look at the stream
Everybody,
chat. It's just
thanks,
distracting.
Tricks 2001. Tricks. Knows all the stuff. You might as well be a game
Tricks
shark.
Knows the tricks.
Mm-hmm. Might as well be a game FAQ.
What's your pal Tricks 2001 here
Tricks
with the best
tips.
Civilization
I
6
like
speedrun
like
strats?
Great spot for a city if the whales give food. Oh, that's fish. Okay. We should actually probably pop out there. Oh, no. Shit! That's not what I wanted, damn it. Don't auto select units for me, you piece of fuck. What am I looking at? What do I even have selected?
Who are these guys? Are these
balloons?
Wrong. What are they? Are they sending balloons? What are those?
One can only hope.
Purple things.
This might be a better spot for a city right here, because we get two fish. Yeah, I think my next city is going to go down right here. Sure, they're just being nice and friendly over here, Rome.
Just visiting.
Oh no!
Just trying to be
the Roman scout is stuck here. Oh wait, they can just walk over my borders. Okay, that's nice. I'm really kind of shocked.
Do you have an open borders agreement?
No. Maybe. How do I open diplomacy?
Do they just not respect your borders? That's Josh Borders. Who does he think he is?
Their relationship is unfriendly.
He keeps smack-talking you.
He doesn't have a sword out this time, though.
It's because he's not even afraid of Josh anymore.
So what did you name the second city that you founded, Josh? I didn't see.
I named it Butt Town. -1, unknown reason. +7, unknown reason. -6, unknown reason. I didn't found a city yet, damn it.
We didn't even find a city yet.
I have not founded a city.
Writing means
civilization,
sharing.
More like poopalization. Am I right, chat?
Josh thinks he's playing Sim City. He's just gonna build the one.
Yep. we're gonna want.
Look at the Romans. They've got more than one city.
Actually, let's not do that.
Even the barbarians have multiple cities by this.
This is really at the Eureka.
Go take their stuff.
Hey, you know what they say? When in Rome, steal all the cities of the Romans and burn them down.
When in Rome, steal Rome, because you really need a second city.
Well, we're gonna get that second city up, and then I might actually just go straight for Rome, because I have my unique unit available now.
Alright,
Constantinople.
You win. Constantinople. That is beautiful.
So what's the status on Stonehenge, Josh?
Every nation lives by exchanging.
Two turns.
Give us that Henge stat.
We have foreign trade. We don't want that.
Damien Lucifer says, tell Josh that he needs more than one city. So, that should be... That's
I didn't
helpful.
Realize. Do I really need more than one city?
This is, right? This
are you guys
long.
Sure?
I think you should have built Woodhenge first. Bamboo Henge.
We'll call it Lame Henge.
We'll just call it Stone, and then just stop working on it.
There, it's done.
Be like Nouveau Art. Did they found Rome, like, after, behind a mountain pass that's an excellent defensive choke point?
It's possible. That may be exactly what they did.
Pretty smart.
Come on, Stonehenge.
You got a second city there to the south.
Rumor has it. Can you imagine? Oh, yeah, we did it!
Label on it, though. Helping you drag a 50-ton stone
18 miles across the countryside. Congratulations, you stacked rocks.
Yeah.
Another
20 like that, then we can party. These are cool. Grants free great profit.
I like how you built the 3,000. You built the 3,000-year-old version of Stonehenge instead of
yeah. To our lands. What did the original look like?
Some torches in it. To Stonehenge
and rejoice, for the time has come to found a religion for ourselves. I'm pretty sure the original had a food court.
We have.
You know, if that's wiped away by
holy
time.
Shit. We have Siddhartha, Gautama, I believe.
Okay. And why do you need to send them to Stonehenge to do anything?
We need to find a religion. We're gonna fucking do it, Mumbles.
Yeah, but why?
Great person
why
activated.
Do you need Stonehenge for that?
Yeah.
Because it's a place where I can
He's
find a religion.
Go into Stonehenge and I like how you built the temple and then founded a religion.
She's a production. settler.
Yeah.
You're done building the thing, and it's like, all right,
all
who
right.
are we going to worship here?
Which of these icons should we use, Mumbles?
I can't see
the... You'll see them in a minute.
Describe them to me. Okay, here we go.
And then there's
What's the one
a bunch
that looks
more.
The most like cannibalism?
The crow.
Okay, not the cow head. Can't be the cow head.
Is there
because
a crow?
There's a
lion. Is
there
line. A raven or a crow?
There is the...
Is there a whale?
There's this Zoroastrian one that looks...
Is there a whale?
Kind of eagle-ish.
Do the butterfly one. Do the butterfly.
Is there just like... It looks like a dude's head, but with a bite taken out of it.
Do the butterfly, because people will
you
be like,
butterfly
oh,
or do you want
butterflies.
This, which is like a dude on eagle's wings.
Butterflies are fucking metal.
Yeah, no, butterfly, because people are like, oh my god, butterflies are so pretty, I bet they're not going to eat our face, and then we eat their face.
Oh wait, we can't name Zoroastrianism. Okay, so, yeah. What do you want to name it, Mumbles?
Butterfly it is.
I want to name it, cannibalism. Cannibalism.
So with the pauses and the ellipses.
That's really important.
Alright. There we go. What do we want for beliefs for this religion?
Beliefs? Eating people is okay.
People are delicious. People are
feed
delicious.
The world. Look at
belief.
That, it's right there.
People are
shrines
and
temples
sacrifice?
Output food equal to their intrinsic faith output. All
yeah,
wonders
because
provide
everybody
plus
who
for
goes
faith.
To worship at the temple is eaten.
May purchase campus in Theater Square District buildings for faith.
Yeah, anything to boost food would be thematically appropriate.
Yeah, do it. All right,
feed the world with cannibalism.
We can just role play that you're eating people.
Yeah.
See, you think that it's like feed the world, as in give everybody in the world food, but we interpret it as feed the world to someone else.
Feed the world to us.
To a divine butterfly.
Let's see here. Man, there's a lot of these.
Choose your religion beliefs. Building. Other building. Holy smokes, there are a lot of those.
Yeah, fucking seriously. Foreign cities that follow this religion. Wait, that's a crusade? Plus 10 combat strength near foreign cities that follow this religion. No.
Because you're gonna liberate them from the oppressors.
Come on, we're here to free you from your overlords that have given you indoor
stewardship
plumbing and
good.
Hygiene.
Each campus or commercial hub district in a city provides this with this religion provides plus one science and plus one gold, respectively. Or you do like one of the we can make.
Sure, that doesn't sound boring.
Yeah, let's do that. All right. Found this religion. Cannibalism is our new religion.
Cannibalism. We did it, guys. Game over. End game.
Yeah, stream done.
This is it. We're done.
What we got over here?
Alright, now start yelling at the Romans until they also follow it. It's like, you guys gotta believe it's something. Specifically
come on, guys,
my
give
thing.
Me one of your cities. You've got like three or four, and I've only got the one, and that's not fair, man. That's not cool. Give me one of your cities, man.
Okay,
you give
I have
me
a
one
question.
Of your cities, and I'll tell you about cannibalism.
Jesus, gosh. Rome is really well defended.
Josh, I have a question from you from JimmyDC99. Can you ask Josh why the AI sucks ass at Crusades in CK2?
What? I don't know. Because, like, the AI in CK2 is, like, really bad in general.
We want numbers and facts, bro.
I don't know. Oh!
Just we met
Cleopatra!
Built a second city.
Would you like to hear the marvels of cannibalism?
Cannibalism.
She's gonna be so impressed when you tell her about all your city.
We'd love to sample your
She's got sass down.
Oh, apparently. She's being way too flirtatious. Chill out, lady.
She also has,
with eating people.
Has a severe case of Pixar face.
Yeah.
Well, that's the case in a lot of these games.
Josh, there's crabs there. Found a second city.
I'm building a fucking settler!
That's what they all
fuck
say.
You, Trajan! Everybody wants me to fucking build a new city! I don't need this from you guys!
Okay, alright, alright, alright. If you don't want to build a city, I'm sure you can still win this game.
I mean, if even the NPCs are starting to whine about it, then...
It's not even the first time he said that!
Get off Josh's back.
I did
this is like
the
a stealth tutorial
expansion in Civ 5. It was, or not the one city challenge where you try and be like one city for the whole game. It was not worth it. Like, it was actually kind of interesting in the early game, but in the late game, it's just hitting the next turn button over and over again.
Oh, he's denouncing me for not building a fucking city. You control very little territory is the reason he denounced me. God damn it!
Whoa.
Jesus. Put that sword back, yo.
Chill out, old man.
Wait, did he denounce you because you have a lot of laws?
No, because I don't have a lot of territory. It's the reason why I was denounced.
Well, have you told him about your city? Maybe that'll impress him.
Fuck you!
Hey, can I send a delegation over? And she's like, nah. They don't know you that well.
You really
yet.
Build elephants?
Tell him to just give us one of his if he thinks it's so important we have more than one.
Well, that's what we're going
to
do.
We'll try. Okay, we agree to try
Candy.
Having more than one city. You donate a city, and we'll try it out for a while, and if we like it, we'll keep it. All right? Will that make you happy?
Is that a settler?
How do I send envoys quests? Send a trade route to the city-state. Reward one envoy. Alright. Don't know how that's gonna work. Alright, two turns and we'll have a city. Then we'll start building fucking military units and go take Ostia.
Yeah, you should take Rome's second city and then burn it to the ground and then start harassing them for only having one city.
That
don't
does
think
sound
that's
appropriate.
Funny. I'm pretty sure. Candy looks like a nice place to live.
Well, it's currently being attacked by Brazil, so maybe not.
The upsides and downsides.
What? Oh, huh. Alright, we're gonna put you here. Oh, I should, there's a way to, like, form a... Yeah. Escort formation with the settler. Cool. So now the settler won't leave my archer. Choose production. Let's get some fucking horse archers. Oh wait, we can get an encampment.
Whoa, you can give a horse a bow? That's amazing.
Let's put our encampment over here. Is that a hill? No. Let's put it over here. We got the money for that. Yeah. Build an encampment. And that'll be where the military units pop out.
Brazil is approaching my return. We have obtained great knowledge.
Each of us is carving Mumble, a stone. Somebody's trash talking your boy Solus. You're not going to take that.
Seamus, I hate
Next
Solus.
Thing you know, they'll be trash talking Anders.
It was luxuries like air conditioning. Do not troll me. I hate Anders with almost as much as I hate Solus.
We want the plus one reproduction for horse units. Builders, settlers, protection. Let's get builders because we're probably going to build a builder in our new city.
What if Anders and Solus hooked up?
Oh. Blah. Blah.
So I got a question. Josh.
Yeah.
Those civic cards that you get, do they have influence on what happens beyond strictly the numerical bonuses that they give?
I don't know.
Because it looks like really cool at the start, and now it just looks like you're rejigging cards to get the bonuses that you need at that specific moment.
It seems like it, yeah.
I'm kind of worried that, like, it seems to be losing its impact for me after an hour of watching a stream.
It seems
a little silly.
This interface, the more I think about it, the more this looks ridiculous to me. Like, this stuff, like, they need to scale the UI with the resolution. It feels like they designed a game for...
Yeah, so there's a... apologies, I will look elsewhere in the future.
It's also small.
So I'm running at 1440p. There's an option in graphics to change the UI upscaling says only available at certain resolutions, but apparently my resolution isn't large enough for the UI upscaling to work. So, I guess nobody bothered to test this game on this monitor resolution.
But your resolution is massive. How does that work?
All right. So, have we founded our third city yet?
God, you people just don't give up.
Also, did Brazil smack talk you for having too many cities?
No, Brazil was mad that I settled right next to him. Cleopatra's mad that I don't have an army.
You are not worthy to bask in our presence.
I mean, I'm just gonna have to fucking kill all these people.
So I figure, like, if you
she's
an army,
denouncing me, because we're weak.
So Cleopatra will be happy. Then you use the army to kill Brazil. That way you won't be settling near them. So they'll be happy. And all the cities you steal from Brazil are going to make Rome happy, too.
Or we could just fucking kill Rome.
Oh, is she not going to flirt with you anymore?
I guess not.
Mad.
She's mad because you're weak.
I feel like that really close purple city that I can't read because this interface is terrible. Yeah, that one.
I keep misreading it for Ostagar.
You put it there just so you could take it.
Yeah, it does not look well defended.
Yeah, it's way in your territory and it's very small and fragile. And they keep giving you shit for not having enough cities, so he's almost like, I dare you to take it. I'll bet you won't even take
it. That's a trick, right? Because then Josh will be the one declaring war, and he'll be the asshole in the eyes of the international community, consisting of Brazil, Cleopatra, and Rome, and barbarians. And then Caesar can be like, he attacked me first, I'm gonna wipe a civilization off the map. Herp, herp, herp.
It's built from fucking horse archers.
Actually, it's why
a
are
lot
so
of
many
fucking
of,
horse archers?
Yeah,
why are so many of Caesar's dudes standing right outside your main city?
I think he's about to attack me.
My liege. Maybe they're just sightseeing. Like they're like, we heard you build a Stonehenge. We gotta get some of that.
Yeah, they're coming to see your henge, man. Yeah,
they want
a lot of people are coming to see your henge.
Can we ask him to
leave?
You're
gonna be rich. You just charge these guys admission, and you'll make a bunch of money. Coming to see your henge.
That's a tourism victory right there. Maybe you could, like, suck up to him real quick.
Have I ever told you how much I admire your chicken neck? And your
you
boot plate that you're wearing?
Very bad posture. I mean...
What is this doing here?
Your pauldrons are the envy of the modern world.
I need a couple more turns
to get
my horse archers rolling here.
No problem, I'm sure Caesar will wait.
Oh,
those
yeah.
Those chariots can just do donuts right outside the main gates.
It looks like we're going to be back down to one city here really soon.
I have the option but to build horse archers here as well. So the cool thing about Scythia is whenever you build a light cavalry unit, you get another light cavalry unit. So we just built two of these things.
Huh. That's,
so
that's a little
bad,
actually.
So now we're only outnumbered 3-1. Great.
These are very special horse cavalry units. Ranged cavalry units, is what I was gonna say. That's why Josh is putting them right next to the melee dudes.
They're one range. They're not really ranged cavalry units.
And why are they called horse archers? That's falseness in advertising.
They're actually just dudes.
Well, the thing with range is that they can attack without being retaliated against, basically.
That's messed up.
Can I purchase 400 gold for that? We'll be able to do that in a turn or two. Let's get some more horse archers going. Oh, wow, they turned away. Where are you going, Rome?
We came, we saw, we changed our mind.
I'll get some promotions going for these guys.
We bought some Stonehenge t-shirts at the gift shop.
Peace out. So now you've got a bunch of horse archers and you're like, huh, I have this big army and what should I do with it?
Well, I'm not there yet.
Like, once
but that
I
will
do
be
this,
the thing that we once that will happen.
Right. But once the AI goads me into making a big army, I'm like, well, I don't want to, like,
well, yeah.
Hire it.
I mean,
I
this is
really
the whole point. This was the idea. Oh, Jesus.
It was all
the idea was for you to get spooked
Egypt founded
by
Buddhism.
Caesar and then quickly build. Have you talked to them about cannibalism? Now that you have these cool horse archers,
I don't know how to do that.
Might actually like you again.
There's some gold from this.
You
be able to purchase
a really cool profit. These barbarians do not know what is happening.
Oh, that didn't give me too.
One moment, you.
Interesting.
Teetering on the brink of death.
Vessels large may venture more, but little boat.
Alright, we got sailings, so now we can.
Have? This, are strategic resources still a thing in this game? Or
yeah, I don't have any, which is a problem. There's iron over here, which is probably why this city got built.
But horses are no longer strategic resource in Imbibe.
That's the special, one of the special things with this horse archer is it doesn't require horses. Figure that one out.
How?
It's not a horse archer, it's a horseless archer. They just didn't have enough room in this tiny stupid interface to print the whole thing.
The horses are actually two additional warriors
working.
In horse costume.
Oh, hello. They're back.
And this time, it's personal.
Okay, this time for real, guys. We're actually going to invade it. Alright?
So those chariots, do those require horses?
I don't know.
Are those
these
just show horses?
Brazil just declared war on Rome. What?
He's
gonna turn
oh, oh man, that's again. That is some crazy shit there. Let's
nice.
Watch
like
what happens.
Crazy, you mean
and
convenient?
Mop up. Jerusalem just declared war on Brazil.
Are they fighting in your backyard? They,
so what happened here is it looks like Rome was getting ready to attack me. And then
politics is the art of the
oh sweet we can
just found
the
city
new,
right outside actual Rome.
Yeah, so Rome was getting ready to attack me and then they went up here and founded this thing and declared war on Rome. So we're going to go and take Ostia. Well, we'll see what happens here, how this shakes out, and continue to build up our military forces. Meanwhile, we've got a government thing. We can change to a classical republic, an autocracy, or an oligarchy.
All of those sound boring.
Okay, change it into an olive garden, like you said.
20% experience for oligarchy doesn't sound bad. All land and melee units gain +4 combat strength. Low Autocracy sounds cool. Capital receives plus one boost to all yields and bonus to wonder production. Let's do Oligarchy. Alright, so we've got diplomatic stuff. And, let's do diplomatic leak for that. And we can put anything in our wildcard policy slot.
How about the one where you get extra great general points? That sounds like something that could be useful.
Yeah, that sounds good.
I know, right?
Okay. I have to go.
Oh, bye, Mumbles.
I have to go do things. It is Nicholas' birthday. Thanks for having me. I will see everyone later. Goodbye.
Thanks for founding our religion. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
And then
now who's gonna random chat now? Hold it.
Let's get two more horse archers plus the two we're building in that place, and then we should have enough, I think, to go after Rome here. We're losing a lot of gold per turn.
Our city's very vulnerable to invasion again, because that's something that I feel like 5 especially...
Yeah, 5 was kind of a problem with that.
Like, it was really hard to, like, take a city in 5.
Mm-hmm.
It was easy especially to wipe out their army, but then there was this stupid city, and you, like, couldn't take it, and it was very frustrating.
I don't really get a way to see strength score here.
I saw that. Somebody said the mods are gone, so everybody be nice to Josh now. I'll have none of this.
Do you want to field, like, some spoiler warning
I'm
questions?
I'm watching you chat.
While we're doing this?
Wait, what? What, Josh?
Do we want to field, like, some questions for spoiler warning while we're doing this, or...?
That's a great idea. I wish we'd thought of it before Mumbles left. We can do that now, or should we wait until Chris gets back? You know what? Let's
Chris
just
gets
do
back
it.
If you
Let's
want.
Just do it, man.
Yeah.
Okay, here's one. Dear Diecast, is there something else you wish your fan base was into so you could do shows about that as well? Preferably, I'd like to hear about an interest you know your fan base won't convert over to, but any answer works. Your widest nerd, wide and nerdy. Okay, so something that we wish the audience was into so that we could talk about it without boring everybody.
The Lord made us all out.
This goes for you too, Jaren. Like, mm-hmm. Is there something
well,
you
I can
like,
answer
really
for
want to talk about that you're like...
It's wrestling.
Okay. Yeah, that is definitely true for her. Just definitely wrestling. She's really shy about bringing up wrestling because she's always afraid people will be like, oh, it's boring.
Which is an interesting contrast to her Twitter account.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Her Twitter account is all wrestling.
I mean, my personal stuff is mostly, like, the things I want to talk about, I have this website that I write on.
Yeah.
For a while, I thought it'd be funny to talk about visual novels 1 month for a year, and now that month is coming up and I'm paralyzed with hatred because I really don't want to immerse myself in more of that awful, awful garbage. But I kind of have to because I promise. There are so many new Sakura games again.
I was gonna say Trek, but then I kind of realized I think our fan base is into Trek. It's just,
just
most
not
of them
into
are into
my
like
ideas about doing Star Trek commentary. Yes.
Yeah, and they're not into TNG. Everybody is either original or DS9. There are not a lot of TNG things.
I am into DS9.
Hey, question here from the Mitch88. Has anybody checked out the new Hitman? That's another game I don't want to spend money on this. I've been meaning to get the new Hitman, like, all year, and it's just I keep buying other games. I feel bad. It's like they made Absolution, and it was terrible, and I complained about it. And then they fixed everything, and they made this wonderful new game, and I didn't buy it. And now I feel like a jerk. I feel like they made this just for me, and I ignored them. Wrong.
It was such a good year for video games, though. Like, even...
Yeah.
Not counting the missteps, there's so many. Right now, I'm looking at Shenzhen IO, which I want to review, and then this game is here, but also the newest update to Stellaris just came out, and Clockwork Empires is finally releasing, and Endless Space 2 is going to open access, and there's so many video games.
I know Chris has played the new Hitman, and he seems to be pretty positive on it. Josh, can you get the new Hitman?
I have not played the new Hitman. It's on my list of stuff that I want to mess around with. But
someone, Philomorpho in chat asks, what's the spoiler warning mailbag email again?
Diecast@shamusyoung.com.
So you can...
Yeah, diecast@shamusyoung.com. It's at the top of every podcast post in the header image.
Oh, there you go.
The ranking is DS9, the original series, TNG. I like how you didn't... you didn't even put Voyager or Enterprise in there.
I like Voyager.
And you know what?
That's mostly because...
I don't have anything against DS9. I just never got into it. I watched a few episodes, but I always felt like coming into the middle of a soap opera and I was too far out of the loop. And I like TNG, aside from the it's troubled period, it's awkward early adolescence. Voyager, I really liked a couple of the characters, and I wish they could have been in a better show.
Yeah.
For me, it was Voyager was one of the television shows that we would watch after dinner. There's, like, Voyager and Buffy the Vampire Slayer and Charm. Those are the ones that I remember.
Only 90s kids will remember.
So I have an affection for it that's probably not entirely earned.
Oh. All freight on canal. Why is 20 minutes with so sporadic? I love that show. That's a good question. That's sort of our... Oops, we can't do spoiler warning this week. We'll do it 20 minutes with. And I have yet to participate in one. So maybe it's my fault. I don't know. I think it's good, too. I think it's a wonderful thing. It would let us cover more games, talk about more diverse stuff, rather than just beating one game into the ground. It just hasn't worked its way into our routine yet, is the only excuse I can give.
Math709 asks which members of the spoiler warning crew have actually watched Babylon 5.
Not me.
I watched, like, the first season, I think.
I don't actually know what Babylon 5 is. Like, I know enough cultural osmosis to be able to place it, but I don't actually know what Babylon 5 is. So.
Fucking.
I keep confusing it with Deep Space Nine.
John Babylon 5. Who's a spaceman, who has adventures in space, apparently.
He kills the aliens and he doesn't afraid of anything.
He meets the king of space, he fights against the
evil
space.
I want to meet the king
monsters.
Of space. How do I meet the king of space?
Do you ever plan on covering The Walking Dead Season 2? I don't. I heard it was nihilistic, and I already thought that
Seamus and I were the only ones who played The Walking Dead Season 2. Or not Seamus, Rutskar and I were the only ones who played The Walking Dead Season 2, I think.
Everything people said about it sort of made me not want to play it. I like the story, the closure we got. I don't want to undo the closure I got from the first season just so that we can have more nihilism. No, I don't want to do that. Damien Lucifer says, watch SF Debris' Babylon 5 series and you'll get up to speed in a jiffy. Man, SF Debris is just aces. I love, what's his name, Chuck?
Yep.
That guy is so good. He does, he's good to us.
They are abandoning Ostia.
Yeah, I mean, you're kind of flooding it with the horses.
My army is not weak, Cleopatra. What are you even talking about? Did you see me wipe away the Romans?
Well, I mean, it's kind of silly that they built their city on the wrong side of the river.
They really did.
They're like, oh, right.
They also don't have walls.
Other bridge. Yeah, walls are for chumps.
You said build the city on the near side of the river. I thought you meant near to them, but I see what you meant now. Okay, can we move it? Is it too late to move the city?
I mean, apparently that's what's happening. I don't know, the city just faded out of existence for a bit.
Couple minutes, you know. That's how it goes.
Do you wish you ever they ever made a sequel to Mass Effect?
So, people are also referencing the Tales of the Borderlands game. Did any of you ever play that?
Oh,
I have
shit.
It installed.
He's got legions.
Once. I heard it's good.
Which of course means that he has iron.
Also, Josh, Tentacles tells me to let you know that they called you a bug.
Oh no!
Little Morpho, that was happy accident. Summonorum? Wow. This text is too small and I should make it bigger. I sort of am glancing over at the chat, but I am not being diligent in my duties of watching the chat. So I'm
a monster, Seamus.
I try to do it more consistently, but whenever Josh does something cool, I throw the stream to full screen to be able to see it, and then I forget that the chat exists.
Indie Panthro, the last Star Trek game I played was Star Trek Elite Force. The one where you're a member of Voyager's team and you fight the Borg with super rifles and it's a first-person shooter.
Oh, they're just straight up disbanding like my units randomly when I'm out of gold. That's not good.
Wait, what?
My units are getting disbanded because I'm out of gold.
No, I got that. That sounds entirely too realistic that your soldiers are saying, yeah, we're not getting paid. Well, fuck that.
Sell this. Actually, no.
You should be glad that your soldiers are... You should be glad that your soldiers aren't just fucking defecting to the Romans. Maybe these guys are paying.
Hey, on topic, what's everybody's favorite iteration of Civ?
Twisted Ellipses.
Well, 4.
Yeah, Twisted Ellipses. 4. I think 4 is the common one. I think I put the most... I played, like, 2 or 3 was my first Civ game. And then... No, you know what? Alpha Centauri. Alpha Centauri is the correct answer for me.
That is a good answer. For me, it's like... I think... I find it hard to conceptually tell 3 and 4 apart, but I think it was 4 that I just played a whole bunch with my brother. Where we would open a big map, and I would be Russia, and he would be America, and we would fill the map with AIs and just be friends and kill everything else. So it was a very cooperative civilization experience.
The only memory I have of Civ 4, and I know everybody considers it the best in the series, but my first game of... Yeah, I got it, like, on Steam sale, and in my first game, I ran up the tech tree, got tanks, and not just the first tier of tanks, but, like, the second tier of tanks, and then I went over to kill somebody that, you know, they were way behind me, and they had spearmen, and I just, you know, okay, I'll just roll over these guys, and their spearmen completely annihilated my tanks. And I raged about it, and somebody's like, well, no, see, technically, tanks are like a mounted unit, and spears are a cannon. And I'm like, no, it is tanks! Not spears! There is no arguing this point. And I'm sorry, I'm done playing this game forever. That is nonsense.
Secretly, they were antimatter spears.
They must have been. Or lightsaber spears. Mm-hmm. That would be a pretty hard
like
counter spearers. Tanks. Spear sabers. Light spear, yeah, something.
Mm-hmm. Or they were just normal spears, and your tank commanders just saw that and started laughing so hard that they all choked.
I think probably my guys like got out of the tank. They hadn't figured out the tank yet, and they were like, okay, the tank brought us to the battle, and they get out, and then they're like, wait, we're doing this wrong, aren't we?
It's that Warhammer 40k image of a guy with a sword in a tank. Don't drive me closer, I want to hit them with my sword.
they're trying to hit the guys with the turret. They're using
what?
The turret as a melee weapon.
Brazil made a trade route with Ostia, the Roman city that they're at war with. What?
Are they still at war, I guess is the question.
I think so.
Are you still trying to conquer this tiny little hamlet?
Well, arrows don't work super great against cities.
See, this annoys me too. Like, you have surrounded a city for several turns. In any context of medieval warfare, you win. Okay, they're done. They're starving, and you get the city. It's yours now.
So this is actually a thing that
Civ 5 had this problem, and it just turned. It turned warfare into a chore.
Well, I mean, if I had built melee units, this would be different. I'd probably be doing a lot more damage. But this is kind of true, though, in that, in general, you had, like nomadic horse archer kind of wielding guys, like the Scythians that we're playing, and I'm kind of emulating that with all my, horse archer units here, and they could roll in and pillage stuff really easily, but they wouldn't be able to really take cities. What do we got here?
Let's see. All freight on canal. Oh, wait, no, who was it? Somebody said, oh yeah, all freight on canals. Question from a non-civ player, is Josh winning? Good question. Josh, how are you doing, mocking... I know we've been teasing you mercilessly, but how are you doing?
And why haven't you built
I mean, Rome is in full retreat right now.
But, like, overall, like, are you thinking, yeah, I'm on the course to win this game, or are you, like...
It depends a lot on whether Rome starts rolling in with their Legion units, because they could potentially fuck me up pretty hard. What's going on?
You still only have two cities, though, and that is worrisome since everybody else is like on their third or fourth.
Why are you focusing
on
production?
Rome isn't
going to
be on their third or fourth. For much
like the idea generally here is to not necessarily settle a lot of my own cities, but to.
So yeah, that's actually a question that I had. Is it still?
Oh, there we go.
Like in Civ 5, where you conquer a city and you can either puppet them or take them over, but
no,
way,
that is out. That is
sad about
thankfully
it.
Gone.
They just ditched
Wait,
a whole
gone?
Lot of Civ 5.
Civ
5 right?
had some really awful right? mechanics. So in Civ 5, so first off, in Civ 5, happiness was a global thing. So, like, if your empire, like, if there was unhappiness, like, you were not happy, your entire empire was unhappy. Would fuck up all your cities. Previous Civ games, happiness was city-based. In this game, it's city-based. But when you conquered a... when you got more cities, you would get more unhappiness at a rate that scaled like so that you really couldn't maintain a whole lot of cities at any one time. There were ways around that with certain strategies, but in general, you didn't want to go more than, like, six or seven cities that you actually control. But if you go conquesting, you're going to get a lot of cities, right? So the solution they had to that was if you conquered a city, you would have the option to take it and annex it, and then it would just become one of your cities like normal, raise it, or you could turn it into a puppet state. And this would still be, like, your city, but it wouldn't...
You
wouldn't be able to choose what you were building or change the way the people were like your citizens were working or anything like that. I don't think I can walk into this with this, so I need to send my melee unit over and take the city. So like basically, it didn't contribute to your unhappiness, but you weren't able to really control it at all. It would just decide what it was doing. You could give it, like, general instructions on, like, hey, you should probably be focusing on production or whatever. But generally, it was just, like, running its own thing. And that was boring. Alright, we took Ostia.
Oh, finally. Okay, I've turned up my microphone. Is that better, Anti-Panthro?
There's now, like, a weird... buzz.
It's definitely noticeable for me. Yeah.
All right.
But yeah, that whole mechanic.
Jigalag 35. Can you tell Josh to get good? See, I could do that, but he's like 100 times better than me at this, so I'd sort of be insulting myself. But yeah, get good, Josh.
Specifically, get good. There's no get good, or no get good. But get good. Also, maybe build some battering rams, because why not?
I'm still losing a bunch of money.
Convert some of your horsemen into mechs.
Okay. I didn't think of that.
So, I have a more of an actual question again. Like, I'm looking at your districts and buildings list, and it's like there's a bunch of buildings under City Center, but there are also a bunch of buildings under Encampment.
Promote.
And how does that work?
What?
Can you tell us how that system works?
What do you mean?
Like when you were in Flail, the City Center.
I do not have Overwatch.
Right, I'm looking at it now. So what do you mean?
Well, it was in your capital when you had the encampment.
Oh, okay. So, districts can have buildings built in them. So I can build barracks in my encampment.
So is this a matter of you have to choose very carefully what you do, or if you build every district type, you can build every building?
I think you can just build buildings in them. But districts get, like, certain adjacency bonuses with one another, and certain districts don't like being near other districts. So you kind of have to plan out where you're going to put stuff.
But how many districts are there? Like, is it valuable to build more than one encampment, or do you just build an encampment and that's it for that city?
You can't build more than one encampment in a city. My troops are merely passing
by. So it's just like an extra layer of abstraction over what you're
really interested
in
declaring war on you right now, Brazil. Maybe later. Something cool about these is they ignore zone of control.
Your horse archers.
Jimmy DC99 is commenting on how much you like the Sakura games, Jarent. Especially Sakura Fantasy. Tell us about how much you love that game.
Sakura Fantasy was alright. It was the one I reviewed last year that was the most obviously just porn. Which I sort of respect when...
I had no idea what kind of game I was asking about when I posed this question. I figured it was some kind of anime fighting game.
I mean, there was anime fighting going on, just not in any sense that it was controlled by the player. They're all visual novels. There's, not last year, but the year before, like, you had this visual novel come out on Steam called Sakura Spirit. You might have heard of it, you might not have. It was basically softcore anime pornography, and it's kind of garbage. And it's also, I reviewed it as a joke, and it's the single most popular review on my website by, like, an order of magnitude.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So then, the people who made this, Sekai Project, they smelled money. So they decided to just release all their garbage Sakura games on Steam. So if you go to the Steam store and look for Sakura, you find like a whole bunch of 2 and 3 and 4 games like Sakura Angels and Sakura Santa and Sakura Spin Club, and it's old softcore anime pornography, or in some cases hardcore anime pornography, because they also do that.
All Freight on Canal said to me, "Hey, you convinced me to play Honey Pop, and I'm gay." I assume you mean a gay man, because I mean, if you're a gay lady, that game's basically made just for you. You can play as a lady. So, but if you're a gay man, then I guess I really sold the hell out of that game. Like, as a gay man, I gotta ask this, if you don't mind, Alfred on Canals, like, how does the fan service in that game make you feel? Is it hilarious or uncomfortable or just weird?
How do amenities from war weariness, so that's just because it was probably recently conquered. Is that for everyone? Do you also have? Yeah, okay, so it's just because it was recently conquered. I'm not going to immediately be active anyhow. Really weird how unaggressive Rome has been in this game so far.
All Freight on Canals treats it as a joke, basically. Okay, well, I did the same thing, and I'm not gay. And I will defend the gameplay in that game. If you want a match, that's the best match 3 game ever made. Just straight up.
I still like Puzzle Quest better.
But it's Puzzle Quest didn't. Game. Puzzle Quest suffers from a lot of the problems I have with all match 3 games. It's a little too much chaos, little too much. Not enough thinking ahead. Not enough study the board and find this awesome chain of moves that'll do something amazing, which is what I really like about Honey Pop.
Well, that's funny.
Honey Pop, Flail Morpho says Honey Pop seemed really, really soft core. I guess my entire scale is probably not calibrated the way, because it seems so extreme to me, but you know, I don't mess with this stuff very much, so I don't know what's out there.
I finally attacked. Oh wow, that was cool. One of my horses ran off for that.
Oh damn it,
Mr. Doombringer says, Josh, do you feel the AI is handling the hex tiles better than Civ 5 so far?
It feels a little bit better. It's hard to tell, really. Like they saw me start to get horse archers and immediately turned around, and like Brazil was building up, and they were like, "Yeah, fuck that." So that was cool. Oh damn it!
Snow Wraith have not played that.
I have actually.
Seamus tries really softcore porn, a new in-depth series. Considering, like, my family is always hanging around and coming over and talking to me while I play video games, and, you know, I'm, like, in a family room here, that probably would be very awkward and uncomfortable for, like, everybody.
Yeah, I would very much not recommend going near any of the Sakura games, ever. If that's the case, but also just if you value your sanity. Also, to really quickly grab back, I did also play Clash of Heroes. It was actually one of the first games I ever reviewed on the website that is no longer functional. I liked it a lot. It's a really interesting twist on the match 3 formula. It was a little too bad that they couched it in the attempted cinematic reboot of the Might and Magic universe or whatever that nobody asks for and nobody remembers to happen.
Josh, Damian Lucifer wants to know if you've heard of, what is this, Shogun 2?
Shogun
2. Did I say that right?
I think you said that right, Seamus. No, not really. What is that thing? Is that like a, is that a puzzle game? It sounds like a puzzle game. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's probably. It might be another one of them anime porn games. Porn games. I don't know.
It does sound anime-ish, doesn't it?
Could be like Sakura Shogun 2. It would actually fit the naming convention with these terrible names on.
Interesting, you can harvest resources. Permanently remove the sheep from the plot, but it gives you 63 food. We don't want to do that.
So that's like pillaging to the nth degree, or can you only do that when your cities are on?
I have a request from the chat, Josh.
Yeah.
They would like you to ask the Romans to stop shooting you.
They're not really shooting me.
Come on, what for old... Come on, for old time's sake. Next time they shoot you.
I believe I said that in the most recent season.
Did you? And I missed it.
Jerusalem apparently made peace with me, and I didn't notice.
There are still barbarians on this map.
Let's get a fucking granary in here. Fuck that.
What year is it? I mean, actually, in the game.
350 BC. Oh, that horse rode through a mountain. You were typing furiously.
I hope Chris comes back soon. I am starving. Hey, Jarenth, get me a pizza. Bring me a pizza, Jarenth.
What kind of pizza?
If bread is the first necessity. That's an odd question. Recreation
is a bread. I mean, do you not care what I put on a pizza? I'll get you olives and pineapple. Don't think I won't do it.
Alright, that's a good point. Okay, that's a good point. Usually when you don't specify, everybody assumes you mean cheese pepperoni pizza. And they don't want you to put anchovies or pineapple or sushi or any crazy shit on it. Or chocolate drops or whatever those hipsters in California are putting on their freaking pizzas these days. Crowdsource Kickstarter. We'll let it run all month so that we can buy me a large cheese pizza. By the time I've starved to death.
I mean, you joke, but there was that potato salad Kickstarter that I don't remember what happened to it, except that the guy got several tens of thousands of dollars for stupid potato salad. So that could work.
I don't know if we have enough units to take Rome. Do they have walls? They don't have walls.
Don't be such a wuss! Oh my gosh! You act like taking Rome is a big deal. Just take it. It's just Rome. Besides, what have they ever done for you?
There is a when in Rome joke here, but I can't quite pick up on it. It's
what
like...
do I have selected? Oh.
Oh my goodness, Flail Morpho, that picture made me even hungrier. If you are hungry, don't click on that pizza that Flail Morpho just linked. It is of a pizza the size of, I don't know, a bedroom.
A pizza the size of several other pizzas. Taped together.
Oh, that looks really, really good. How do you cook a pizza that big? You'd have to, that'd be the expense in cooking a pizza that big was like engineering an oven and the equipment to like keep it. Yeah. Oh, that wouldn't cook it
properly. Oh, they just straight up killed that guy. What a butt.
They just slaughtered that guy. That's an unreal voice line. And also, your dudes are dead. Are you gonna win this battle, Josh, or are you just gonna have to sue for peace?
I may. Well, if I don't, I'm gonna need to, like. The problem is, I don't have any fucking iron anywhere. Like, I need this iron resource here.
You can buck the paradigm and go for, like, the Silver Age, where all your swords are made of silver.
Hopefully I'm not mispronouncing her name, but Majir 616, or Majir, it wants to know, are you losing yet? Seriously, Josh, do you think you're losing? How do you think you're doing?
Depends on how this next couple turns shake out. I've got 4 horse archers left. Oh, wait, no, I've got 5, but one of them is, like, almost dead, so not much of a use there.
I've never had poutine. Summon Orym.
I also never had poutine, and I think I would probably love it. But then I make terrible decisions about my eating patterns.
Horseless horse archers, ironless soldiers. Twisted Ellipsis says.
I wish it showed you what the fucking...
So you're
adjacency
fighting...
Adjacency bonuses were for these things.
You're basically riding dogs into battle and using wooden swords, as far as we can tell. Or
yeah.
Your guys are just riding each other into battle.
That's it. That's probably the most likely.
So how many...
They take turns being a horse.
How many districts do you have now?
A number of them. I'm building a science district in my capital. Let's bring my fucking
archers.
Can
you show us the holy districts? Just zoom in on it real quick. Because
I don't have a
holy
district.
We're building a lot of stuff and we don't really get to. Did you not? I thought you were building one.
I was, and it turns out it was taking too long, so I'm building a granary in there instead. I'll get back to it.
I'll just finish one of those districts because I want to see what they look like. Or you already have an encampment. That's right. So I'm kind of, like, I see this, and I'm trying to figure out, like, what it represents in the fantasy. Because it's not like every building is outside the city, because a lot of your buildings are inside the city. It's more of like a thematic clustering of here are all the military buildings, and here are all the science buildings.
Rayan 20, seriously, if you have a suggestion for 20 minutes with, send it to diecast@seamusyoung.com. I will never remember the chat. After I stagger away from here and go forage for food, I'm not going to remember anything I've said. And I'll forget what game you suggested. I'll be like, somebody suggested a game for us, and I don't remember what it was.
Somebody suggested a video game, but when and where and why?
This is a good... Jigalag 35 asks, and this is a really good question, are there still city-states? I haven't seen one yet.
Yeah, there's Jerusalem's over here.
In Civ 5.
And we got Candy over here, which I sent an envoy to. We could really use, like, an economic one, because my economy kind of sucks right now, but...
Oh, wow, they are way out there, so... Rome got a defensive mountains and a defensive river, and they were near a city-state. They just got a really good spot.
So basically exactly how it went with normal Rome?
Yeah. Yeah, and you got barbarians. You got like 3 barbarian cities.
Fucking what? An almost dead legion killed my horse archer.
Wow, that guy is fucking badass. He should be the leader of Rome.
That did look absolutely crazy. I finally saw it. And yeah, it looked ridiculous. A guy on foot comes up and, outnumbered and badly injured, defeats horsemen. That looked crazy.
No idea.
Arrow storm.
Although that was probably good for your economy.
So do all units have zone of control normally?
I don't think ranged units exert zone of control.
But if you get them the right upgrade, they do.
Yeah.
Look at
that. Oh, right, they're horse archers. They're horse archers, so yeah, they're bad against melee. I forgot.
Yeah, it
horse
makes
archers.
Sense, but...
It doesn't really make sense that they just stood there. Like, maybe the first dude was like, I could probably take this legionnaire. And then he disemboweled the horse in one hit, and I feel the second horse should have run away at that point.
Yeah, like, wait, I'm on a horse. I have the power to leave, and he cannot possibly catch me. I can just, you know, leave or go in circles around him, and there isn't shit he can do about it.
Damn.
Sometimes the so Jigglax says, they think Brazil is going to invade you at some point, and Zenith asks if you could explain the zone of control.
You think?
Oh yeah, that's.
There's
happening.
A lot of green dudes here on the map, and I don't think they're here to play football.
There. Let's see how Rome feels about peace.
So while you do
Damien Lucifer asks, are we still on Terrace? It feels like it.
So if I put... Okay, so...
Beard of the Evangelist.
Cannot accept this...
Josh, can you... What the hell is that?
Maybe he just wanted you to sharpen his sword.
It's not interesting.
I mean, I can't read the text.
All right.
So I'm gonna assume he got here and he was like, my sword is dull. Can one
of
your advanced dudes sharpen this?
Come back, Rome.
Do they
be
have
back
a
for you
relic?
Later. They have some sort of, some sort of special thing that I have no idea what it does or how it works.
They've got a thing that you don't know what it does.
Yeah.
You should be friends with Brazil. Like, open some trade routes.
Don't have any traders to do
and
that.
And then
right
stab
now.
Them in the back.
Catapult's pretty good to have. I mean, Brazil, going to war with Brazil would be smart to get this iron resource if I could build up an army capable of actually dealing with them. Fuck. Oh, damn it.
Did Brazil declare war on you?
No. Oh, okay, they didn't get my horse archer.
So three legionnaires lose to one horse archer. And leave one horse archer standing. But one legionnaire can kill two horse archers.
You know, this start really kind of sucks. I've got no strategic resources here to do anything with.
You had
I don't have
strategic...
horses?
No, you had tons. At the beginning, you had tons of strategic Oh, wait, those were barbarians. Sorry.
Fuck you, Seamus. I got no horses, no iron.
They're a renewable source of iron in the swords that stuck into your peoples. That would actually be something, though, if the barbarians had iron swords. You should talk to Cleopatra. Maybe she thinks you're cool again.
Yeah, talk to
so her. I'm going to go ahead and say I don't think Josh is doing very well here. I think he's got a bad start, and I think maybe a second city instead of Stonehenge would have been better if I can backseat drive a little bit with some retro.
We needed our
with 2020
cannibalism.
Hindsight. Yeah. All right, so that was for the fans.
How do they?
So we're losing because of you people in chat. This is all your fault. Josh would have beat the game now if it wasn't for you and your need for cannibalism.
Cannot accept this deal.
You should give him gold. Don't deal. Just, like, send gold to him and beg that he doesn't murder you.
We politely refuse your delegation. Well, they don't want that.
You can look at what Camster said at the in-depth overview of why they hate you.
Yeah, I know.
They dislike me for unknown reasons and like
Josh
me
is going to play next season. Josh is going to be playing Until Dawn. It could be Chris, but it's going to be Josh, just because we're used to that.
I don't know if it could be Chris. I don't know if he has an Elgato. He might.
Well, he's recorded.
A relationship.
I mean, he's put PS4 games in his videos, so he has the ability to record.
Yeah.
Yeah, but would it be the same thing?
I don't know.
How long have we been running?
If Josh is reduced to only giving commentary instead of breaking games for like the whole season, I feel like he'd burn himself out at the end of like the third episode.
The bearded dude is the bearded dude campster, I guess.
I have a beard too.
I have a beard.
Seamus claims to have a beard, but I don't believe him.
It's nearly a beard. It's like it's Tony Stark-sized beard.
That's beardy. So all I have is perpetual stubble. It doesn't actually go anywhere, and I can't shave it off far enough to not make it look like stubble.
I want a full beard, but I can't grow any hair on my cheeks, and so it looks sad.
Send our builder down to improve that food resource.
You could do that. So how are things in Ostia? Are they accepting your divine rule yet?
They're not super happy.
So how's can cannibalism doing? Has that spread to anyone yet?
I think I need to like go and make missionaries, but I don't have a holy district yet, so...
Isn't it the only religion in the world right now?
No, Cleopatra has Buddhism.
Oh yeah, that's a good point.
Twisted Ellipsis, the voice actor strike, I literally found out about it 2 hours ago when my wife told me about it. I know nothing about it, so I don't really have an opinion on it yet. So... I mean, you know, I guess strikes just in general suck, so I guess I can say I'm not happy that it's happening, but beyond that, I have no further comment.
I mean, they're kind of being undervalued at the moment. It's like voice actors, we don't need that in them as part of the game.
Well, I mean, we're going to find out if they're being undervalued. If in a couple years we come out with a bunch of games and the voice acting is just terrible, then we'll be like, yeah, you were undervaluing those people. If they replace them with a bunch of people outside the union and everything's fine, then we'll go, oh, I guess that was okay.
That's kind of
what I really would like. Not that I want any voice actors to go without work, but I wouldn't mind getting some games that just went back to the days of text. It's okay, we'll read. Just make sure the font is bigger than Civ 6, and I'll be glad to read it.
This actually killed, Sunless Sea for me to a great extent, because Sunless Sea's interface was also not scalable at all, and the text font was really tiny. So, like, that game was 80% reading.
I haven't played Submariner yet.
That game was 80% reading, and it was like, I can't read this because it's in this tiny little text box, and all the font is super small.
I guess there's an interesting aspect to that strike, where it's like, you can only tell if it actually has a major effect in 2 years' time or something. And that makes it difficult? Sounds like it makes it difficult.
Oh, yeah.
Is there an unmet player that has, like, almost double your score?
Yep.
Holy smokes.
Oh.
You should find that person and be their friend.
What? Cleopatra, what... Are you calling Rome the barbarians because I beat the crap out of them? Because, like, what is... I wasn't killing barbarians. What are you talking about?
I mean, you've been killing
barbarians.
Those barbarians
you killed 3,000
sure, okay.
years ago?
Yeah, whatever.
News travels slowly in the Stone Age.
She's like, oh, congratulations on founding your first city.
That's why she thought that your army was weak, because she was still working on the assumption that you literally had nothing.
We can make this choke point work for us now. Well, it looks about like Brazil. Brazil might be sending these guys up here to attack Rome, but they're so damn close.
If you really think that Brazil is sending those dudes up to attack Rome,
it's possible. I've seen the AI do weird shit when it comes to pathfinding in these games. He's not doing anything to protect them, though. What, that one just turned around.
A nice bridge in the New York area that you might be interested in purchasing.
How come men have to go into training to learn how?
What the hell was that?
I don't know.
Did he just only turn his catapult around?
I don't know.
Kids in the back wouldn't stop screaming. I'll turn this catapult around. Just you watch. I feel like you should try clicking that assign all policies button and see if it does what it says on the tin.
Assign all policies.
Shit, you found out the secret cheat method.
It would be really swell if... Oh, can I move a unit here? Okay.
Flailmorpho asks, will we ever do a season on the Metal Gear Solid games? I doubt it. I've never been into Metal Gear, and I've never been on that wavelength. I know some people love it. I don't get it. I don't get it. It doesn't look interesting to me. So it would be like hours and hours of me going, yeah, I don't find this very interesting. And that's a pretty intense fandom. I would not do that. We would not get a warm reception from Metal Gear fans to that. And like just jumping into Metal Gear 5, like, can you even imagine? That game is so dense with lore. I'd be like, who's this idiot? And everybody would be like, well, if you played the previous games, you would understand.
I mean, even if you play the previous games, you probably... There's a high chance you still wouldn't understand.
What about the new Naked Norman Reedus game? Which, why is that not just the title of the game? Why did they call it Death Stranded instead of Naked Norman Reedus, the game?
Game where Norman
Reedus
is naked.
Norman Reedus, an interactive VR experience.
Yes! Room scale VR, and Norman Reedus is 30 feet tall and so very naked.
I'm pretty sure Cool Games Inc. did an episode on that.
The fuck?
All Freight on Canals, it's Hideo Kojima's new project after leaving Konami. He's not going to be making any more Metal Gear games, and so he made friends with Norman Reedus of Walking Dead fame, and the trailer for the game has Norman Reedus, CG made Norman Reedus, who looks just like him. It's actually amazing. Naked on a beach, and it's really, really weird, and nobody knows what any of it means. There's a baby there, and there's some people floating in the sky, and you just gotta watch it on YouTube. It's bonkers.
I remember when we were live streaming it, and for all the other trailers, like, we had running jokes or commentary, and then that one came on, and we were just silent the whole time. Because what can you say about that that's funnier than the trailer itself? Not even funnier, just more insightful than that trailer itself.
Their iron remains pillaged, so if I can lure out these legions, then I could potentially go in and kill Rome, because they won't have any more swordsmen if I just keep that resource pillaged. I've got spearmen coming in. I may be able to do this. Ooh, I can claim a great person.
Yeah,
excellent. Great general is probably a good idea.
God, can you just choose?
In fact, it is straight up, I can only get El Cid.
Timoth. Oh, go ahead, Jeremy.
I was just gonna ask, how does this work? Like, you can save your points, or you can... How does this work?
Man, these people are great. Timoth YXL asks, what MMO games would work for 20 minutes with? I actually wouldn't mind doing a
using your barracks.
20 minutes with Black Desert Online and show off like it's action combat.
What does that mean?
I think Black Desert Online is fun. It's a really, really fun game for about 20 minutes. So it works out.
Is he smagshawking you?
I think so.
He totally is. It's like you have some good engineers and architects, and they would be much happier in a civilization that doesn't suck ass. Like Brazil!
Josh, what nation are you? I forget now.
Scythia.
He's the Sith.
You know.
Josh is the Sith.
I thought you were Sumer.
No, we were talking about that earlier.
But
he's denouncing me. Great. Fucking great. This is wonderful.
Why are you so upset? I've been denouncing
you have more great
since we started the stream.
Fuck! I can't make anyone happy!
Shut up, skinny Santa. You're not the boss of me.
You're my real dad. So I'm getting the same sense that I had from Civ 5 here, which is that the AI starts hating you for no clear reason. And
they have like agendas that they like. Like Trajan apparently likes people that expand. Cleopatra respects people with large militaries, and so on.
Some Pedro likes
and
it.
Like, Pedro doesn't like it when people have is. More. Great persons than they than he does, I guess.
But that's not really something you can play at, right? Like, it's not that you're gonna be.
Yeah.
I'm playing against Pedro. Better keep my great person count low. So they still just
get like
mad.
Something to worry about. Like, I also I'm not sure if that's his like overall thing right now, or if that's just like
yeah, they had a secret
like
agenda.
So yeah, they have secret agendas, so maybe that's his secret agenda and not his straight up thing there. One of the singers. Bring our great general over here, get the adjacency bonus with the great general, and fucking start beating these guys.
Abnexus says, I actually got into Guild Wars 2 because of the stuff we've been doing, Josh. Like, all the time we spent. I don't know if we streamed it, but I wrote about it. It's funny because the articles... Yeah, it's funny because
the
articles...
Fuck?
About all the things wrong with it are dead on, but they fixed 99% of it. I still play these days. I've been meaning to go back and see if they fixed it, but then I'm always like, oh, there's too many new games.
There's so many new video games now.
There are just too many video games in the world. And I've made it worse this year. I made a video game.
You're a monster, Seamus.
You're part of the problem. I've been thinking about playing some Guild Wars 2 as well to see how it holds up, but it wouldn't be the thing that I enjoy doing in Guild Wars 2, which is hanging out with 20-sided people and just having a good time and playing horrible dungeons. Like, that was what I was enjoying. And then when I played it solo and I was like, I'm just going to level this character, that got old really, really fast. So I just kind of decided at some point that I had good times with Guild Wars 2, and now they're over. And there's other games like...
Yeah, basically, that's how it turned out for me.
That's kind of what Star Wars The Old Republic did for us as well. Like, we played it once, and then at some point it started sucking, and we haven't really gone back since. And I don't think we ever will, but we had good times while we played... Well, we had okay times while we played it. We had an acceptable time chasing down Jedi super weapons. And then at some point, it's just over.
And that was about all we did, was chase down Jedi super weapons.
And Jedi masters that were sick with a mind control play.
Yep.
That I could then kill for no particular reason and didn't do. And also, the twist of storyline so that your character would commit unspeakably evil acts because I won the role. I like that part.
Yeah, that was great.
It's like, should we vent these engineers out of an airlock, or just save them in an incredibly easy, simple way? Nah. I know you're light side, but I've always wanted to vent some engineers out of an airlock.
That was not the way I expected that one to go. And then they magically turned into four dudes again? What the...
Well, you see, when two military units love each other very much,
They look dead to me.
Yeah, what?
It's like a Roman power. It's like, if your legionnaires are dead, they're null. Ha ha, Rome, suckers.
I don't think so. Ah, fuck.
Andy Pato suggests that if you promote a unit, they regain tons of health, so maybe that's what happened.
How could they promote them after them being dead?
The posthumous promotion. It's like a Purple Heart.
Oh, that's not what I wanted. Nothing with that.
But your plan seems to be working, so good job on that.
Well, in that, like, I'm attacking their city before they attack mine.
And also that they don't have their legionaries anymore.
Yeah, there's that, I guess.
And Brazil totally isn't lining up units on your borders.
Yep.
To destroy you. So what does the Great General do?
It increases combat strength.
He's just generally great.
I hate you, Seamus.
Alright, Flamorpho stepped out. He's gonna feed his dog, so you're not allowed to lose the game until he gets back.
Okay.
Do you think you can hold out for that long?
He's got three legions over near me.
Yeah, but you can build a horse archer and get, like, a second horse archer for free.
I'm bombarding Rome down. Let's see if I can get Rome. I'll be in better shape, because Rome's a pretty good city. They've got iron here. I'll be able to build swordsmen.
He's just going to trade capital cities.
No, I've got defenses over at mine. I'm also not sure if he can build any more units, since I've got him totally surrounded now. So he'd have to push out.
Why don't you use nukes?
That's a very good question, Seamus. Something I ask myself often.
Or air units would help.
Mm-hmm. Or like some sort of information warfare campaign, like a propaganda.
Oh, yeah.
Brazil's moving units away from my capital city, Rome, kind of.
Do not do as the Romans. All the world's do a stage, as the Scythians. All the men and women this information campaign plan. Paid for by Scythians.
Oh, the assign all policies is straight up like... just do the thing that was already being done, I think. Like, just to confirm.
Do the thing. That's what all the OK I mean. Buttons should be replaced with do the thing. Name here, guy. Yeah, we early in the game we kind of beelined for religion so we could found cannibalism.
So far, it has like I think 6 adherents, or 7 or something, depending on how many people.
Well, we had 6 adherents, but now we've got 4 fat ones.
Grant Library doesn't just give you a straight up library or
it's
give you a straight
great.
Up technology anymore. It's interesting.
I mean, that was always kind of weird.
It was great, is what it was.
Yeah, if you were the one getting it. So, how's Pokey? Keep forgetting what your city's called. Pokrovka.
I don't know where it is.
Pokrovka.
Pokrovka. They're not attacking it. Like, the two of the legions went back towards Ostia. I guess they realized that Rome is in some deep shit right now? Oh. No, I don't want this shit. I want Ostia. How do I... In fact, I don't want peace with you. I'm gonna take Rome. Fuck you. And then I hope I won't get totally steamrolled by Brazil, which has been jumping way ahead.
Yeah, he's basically offering you everything he has for peace.
Brazil, man. It just... What are they doing? They don't seem to be attacking. They're just like, are they lost? They got an army that went out
know.
In the field 1,000 years ago, and they've been wandering around trying to figure out who they're supposed to be attacking.
Are they ghosts? Is, I guess, my question.
Are they goats?
No, ghosts. They have unfinished business.
Oh, ghosts of goats.
Plane of
goat
eternal
ghosts.
Battle. Mm-hmm. Goats. There's probably a way to pronounce that. I'm just not gonna try.
SL-128, why do you make me remember that show? That episode? Just reference the worst episode of Trek ever.
Which one?
The one where
on,
Janeway went
one.
So fast she became a
oh,
slug.
Fuck
or
that
a salamander.
One. Man.
Yeah.
It was the best episode. It's clear that they don't care anymore, and I respect that.
It's worse than the one where Kirk did the Pledge of Allegiance with a bunch of barbarians. It was, like, worse than that one. Taught the Pledge of Allegiance to a bunch of, I don't know, barbarian Nords.
It's pretty
great,
amazing
barbarians
that
are here to
tell
fight
if
me.
That's a real thing or not. Well, I believe.
Teach them the Pledge of Allegiance, Josh. Okay, so have you won the game yet? It seems like this is taking
yep,
a long
if,
time.
Yep,
how long
just,
can it...
I'm
how long
three
can,
turns away from launching my spaceship.
How long can a game of Civilization take?
How long does history realistically last?
Yeah.
like a few years, five, maybe six. It's kind of gotta be it, right?
Yeah, basically.
Who's ever heard of history that takes more than 6 years? Nobody.
Jiggle egg. Yeah, Janeway basically went Captain Queeg when she went out there and got away from the Federation and their rules. Lost her shit and nobody noticed. There was never an episode where everybody was like, have you noticed that Janeway is kind of a murderous psychopath now? Huh, I noticed that too. How close to modern times are we there, Josh?
What really year is close. It? We're pretty much there.
In fact, we're actually in modern
no, seriously,
times,
like,
can't you tell? It's
no,
175
no, like,
AD.
Okay, so we have crossed that threshold. We are in AD.
Yeah.
Look at that. We are actually in AD. So this war with Rome has at this point lasted about 1,000 years.
Basically, yeah. We're pretty cool, aren't we?
Christopher's, I think Voyager would have been more fun if the writers had realized she was crazy. That was what was really nuts about it, is the writers thought she was a good guy and wrote it as if she was a good guy.
No. Got you on the ropes, Rome.
Yeah, after 5,000 years, you guys are finally slightly at risk of maybe losing one of your cities.
I took Ostia within, like, 15 turns of the war.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's had Ostia for a while. So, do you no longer build roads?
Yeah, you can build roads when you get, like, a military engineer unit, but traders build roads automatically for you.
Huh, that's interesting. That kind of solves the problem of spamming roads everywhere.
Yeah.
Because why wouldn't you?
Flail Morpho asks, will Josh's civilization be the one to invent the spoiler warning show? I think that's one of the wonders you can build. It infinitely negates all productivity in all cities. So
that's it. That's how that one works.
Everybody just takes spends all their time complaining about video games.
Provides perfect defense against friends attacks.
How long can it take to conquer Rome? My goodness.
One measly civilization.
Not even a civilization, it's just one city.
What's that red fellow over there? Is that... Are there actually barbarians now?
There are still barbarians on this map.
They feel like if anyone's gonna take over Rome, it should be us. The barbarians!
Will I take Rome with that? I can't tell. Looks like I might.
See if you... Oh.
Come on, Spearman, you can do it!
Give it a shot.
Yeah! We did it! We conquered the Romans!
Yeah. You stole the book!
That was it?
Good
that
job.
Was all of the Romans? That was
it.
Like...
Yep.
Wow.
They no longer exist.
They no longer... All their dudes that were causing me trouble, poofed. They're gone. We did it.
Like, we're no longer the Romans. And your district planners have worked out the basics of geometry, because apparently, you now have a district.
Yes, I'd like to keep Rome. Good lord.
You sure? You sure you don't want to burn it down? Caesar wants to play his fiddle.
Just keep the receipt and you can return it for full value within a week. So I'm seeing a bunch of arrows and exclamation points and shit,
yeah.
And I'm kind of
what
wondering
that?
What that all means.
Hmm? Can you pull
what
one
are
out
the arrows
me?
Between when were... hexes when you zoom in on a city?
When you were building that district, specifically.
Oh, maybe those are what the adjacency bonuses are. I didn't even notice that.
That's right. But they, yeah, but they were only there when you were placing the district.
Huh. Alright, here comes Brazil.
Time to be perfect friends forever. You and your four cities.
Like, he's still using, like, shitty ancient units to attack me.
Not wait, did 100%. He actually just declare war on you the year after you defeated Rome?
Yep.
It's like, maybe, just, maybe have tried that a little bit earlier. Your timing is impeccable.
I'm gonna need to get some guys over to Ostia pretty quick here.
For that, the club-wielding caveman from Brazil inconvenience her city for more than a microsecond.
Like, they have warriors and spearmen and chariots and then catapults.
Oh my.
It's like, what the...
I mean, it's not like your tech level is that much more advanced.
No, it's kind of shitty.
Mr. I have horses that aren't horses.
Well, I can make swordsmen now.
Will they actually use swords, or...?
How do I have access to the iron, though? This improvement was pillaged. Huh. Oh, whatever.
Yes, all freight. Yeah, green is Brazil. In the game, we're like 100 BC or 100 AD, somewhere in that ballpark.
250 AD.
Someone suggested that maybe Rome is founded on iron.
Maybe.
Is that barbarians attacking your city?
Specifically.
I don't see any.
Oh no, that's Brazil. I get it.
That's Brazil. Brazil's green. Barbarians are red.
I saw the red. I saw the red and thought it was more barbarians. I cannot listen to the music, so I don't know how bad it is, because if I turn on the stream, then I'll hear my own voice being looped back at me, and that's terrible. So I'll take your word for it that the music is terrible. Is another man's engineering.
I just turned the stream audio on for a bit, and I don't hear any music. Which is a terrible music choice in and by itself.
I should probably try to get pikemen. Let's do mathematics.
So what's our immediate term goal here? Because this stream's been going on.
Fight off
this Brazilian attack and then maybe try to isolate and take these two cities. And hope that the rest of these guys don't roll up here. Oh, did they have Catholicism. Seems appropriate for Brazil. Yeah, do we want to keep going here? Or do we want to wrap this up? Because if we want to keep going,
I need to go.
Well, yeah, I also sort of should be asleep.
In that case, that has been a taste of Civilization VI. We conquered the Roman Empire as a bunch of horse nomads, so that's pretty cool. I pulled us out of
basically
that really shitty starting position with the special ability of the Scythians. They get the ability to heal whenever they kill a unit, and they make two of these horse archers that don't cost horses when they build one of them. That's pretty cool.
They go from zero horses to two. That's particularly impressive.
Thanks, everybody, for showing up and checking out this game with us. This was fun. We really should do these more often, Josh.
Yeah, you know, I really wanted to do that Dark Souls stream, but you know what? I could just never convince myself that it was a good time to do it. I definitely wasn't just talking to you about it every week, and you were like, let me think about it.
All right.
And then
okay,
nothing
the
happened.
Chat accepts your apology, Josh.
Yeah, I'm glad that everybody realizes how that all really went down.
All right. Good night, everybody. I gotta go.
Good night, guys.
Bye.
Maybe we'll do some more of this later on.
Weekly occurrence.
That would be cool.
It's a weekly occurrence to watch Josh.
I got Rome. Check it out. Look at this. Beat this whole defensive thing here and everything. It's great. I like it. Civ 6 is pretty good so far. It feels better than Civ 5 on launch, I will say that much. It feels a lot more complex. Seems pretty good. I have no idea what I'm doing half the time. I don't know like how to leverage these districts. I'm probably doing everything wrong, but it seems pretty cool. And it's got that mechanical depth that like I never... I jumped into Civ 5 and I didn't really ever feel like I didn't know what the hell I was doing. Because like it didn't seem like there was that much there to do. I don't think they didn't even have a religion at the start, so it was just straight up like, you have science, you have gold, you have culture, you have your culture trees, make units, laugh at the AI as they cannot put together any kind of military attack, and play the game. And this game is way more complex. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with these. Districts. I'm probably really fucking up city placement, and that's good. I feel like there's stuff to learn and interesting stuff happening, and like it feels like they improved on the stuff that Civ 5 did. These attacks that the AI are putting together feel better than Civ 5 attacks. Although it was weird that he kind of sat here for like 400 years before deciding to actually declare war. Until after I was done with Rome, that was kind of a tactical blunder on his part, a little bit.
Mm-hmm. A little bit.
So we'll see how that all pans out. All right. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.
I don't think I'll be getting it very quickly, but maybe later.
We are finishing. This is a stream ending message that I just came up with right now. Goodbye, everybody. Jareth is leaving.
Yabba dooba. See you
guys next time.